ecological issues. They affect us all. And so, tonight on Second Nature, we'll be recycling some old nature footage.
basic bitches be like this. These days, all the bitches be like this. Why won't anyone call me back? Why won't he call me back? Why won't anyone call me back? Hey guys, I just lost my job and I don't know what to do. I just got fired. I hope you're happy now. And I know the Lord will come and help me when I cry out to my Lord, even though I tried to attack his wife, but surely he will still come and help me because I didn't know what I was doing and I'm drowning, guys. I'm old. I'm old. And did you hear about how Britney Spears just had a...
Bang, let's start the fucking show, eh?
Yo, I'm going to jail.
I will never leave you two.
I don't give a fuck about the fucking law. I'll beat your ass.
Don't come to my channel again. You will be banned.
I'll beat your ass.
You officially enter the wet and handy zone.
Folks, here we are again, another Thursday night. What else do you got to do? Thank you for joining me. We're going to have ourselves a little bit of fun tonight. It's been kind of quiet out there, especially with Vaughn, apparently. As far as I know, I see there's a frost in the chat. Correct me if I'm wrong, please, by all means. But last I heard, Vaughn's still suffering through the darkness over there. I don't know, he's foam building by candlelight or... As far as I know, he's still without power. Now, that doesn't mean he doesn't have access to some power. I'm sure some good soul is helping him, or he's got an extension cord running to the barn, or Ma's, or I don't know. But if someone out there does know, enlighten us. But as far as I know, we got ourselves Von Helton still in the dark situation, folks. But we got a update from Larry Frost he put up on his own YouTube channel just a few days ago. So we're going to check that out later tonight. Yes, folks, it's been quiet all around. Well, not everywhere. There's some other stuff going on in some other communities I hang out, but I don't think we want to see that. So it's pretty fucked up. I've been hanging out over on Clubhouse. And I've been there about a month, and there's been at least three major incidences of allegations of inappropriate people, some of which of questionable age. I'm just going to leave it there. And I just, like, three times... I've been here a month and it's three times already. Anyways, folks, we are facing right now what we call a lulz lull. Don't be frightened. It's normal. We've been spoiled. We've been drinking off the teat, direct, right from the teat, since about 2019. So, I mean, no one's complaining. And in my experience, this is generally the calm before the storm. So something's going to drop. Something's going to drop. Now, we do have a little bit of new stuff we're going to check out tonight. And we got some old stuff we're going to check out tonight. We are going to end tonight with a revisiting of some of the highlights of Vaughn's more notorious abuse. That should be interesting. We're going to go through one of the private playlists that I have up documenting some of Vaughn's abuse towards the kids, etc., etc. That'll be coming up a little bit later. We got Nick Bravo. He is looking into a new endeavor. Wants to get into boxing. And for some reason, in the title of his newest video, he names Darren. I don't know why. Just Darren, I guess, or whatever. I don't know if he's calling him on for a fight or what's going on. We're going to check that out. We'll skim through that. Cyrax, we got some more body cam footage from the police. Apparently, there's been another visit. We'll look into that. We got some Cooking with Cobe classics. We got a very special classic mukbang this evening that I think you all will enjoy a little later on, of course. We got Shrimp and Trucker melting down by himself, which is kind of weird. And we're going to back up to a new classic emo. We're going to revisit something that I think is a classic spaz out, but is not as old as others. So we're going to check that out for sure. And, of course, Tila Tequila made Saturday Night Live, so, of course, she thinks she's relevant. Yep. that's where we're at, folks. So let me just make sure this is all unmuted, ready to go. Oh, and yes, of course. Folks, now is the time to go get your snacks, your frosty mugs, get your blanket, get your butt comfortable. Oh, yes, indeedy. Here we go, folks. Here we go. Listen. I don't know if you can hear it, but oh, I can taste it without it even touching my tongue yet. So let's do it right now. Yep. Not a sponsor, folks. That's some good stuff. All right. Enough yicky-dee-yack, and let's get into it. Folks, thank you for joining me. Thumbs up, subscribe, all that good stuff, because we're on YouTube. We got to say that. And away we go.
You know what I'm saying? As the lows going back up with them things. You know, for reals, though. You know what I'm saying? As the lows can't stop. As he won't quit with them things, you know what I'm saying? He keep pushing with all the fans with them things. Yeah, no, for reals though, you know what I'm saying? As the Lopes never gonna quit with them things. You know what I'm saying? For reals though, God bless the fans. As the Lopes never gonna stop with them things. You know what I'm saying? For reals though, too much up on too much. You know what I'm saying? As when things pressure within upon fighters with things, you know what I'm saying? Loves too much with the things, you know, for real stuff. The fact be so fluid upon things, you know what I'm saying? For real stuff. And get over upon pressure with the things, you know, straight up though. As Loves never gonna quit with the things, you know what I'm saying? As Loves the greatest of all time, the best ever, TGO. The gifted one, you know what I'm saying? As he's never gonna quit. King up on defense, king up on offense, greatest up on timing. God bless the fans. Yeah. Never gonna quit.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Hey guys, Stuart Pidlong, the most targeted citizen. Hope you are well today. It has been a very long and very stressful day for the targeted citizen. I am building this boathouse with zero plans, zero advice, and zero help. Whether it be morally, besides the fans out there that are watching in eager anticipation to watch me fail, or financially. It'd be great if you guys would help, but I guess that people in this world nowadays just aren't near as giving as I am. But that's okay. I guess when I get it all done, I'll just be able to stick my nose in there and say, ha ha, I did it by myself and nobody helped. So today was a day of great learning. I actually knew better and I just got in a hurry. What am I speaking of? I'm talking about when I connecting these pontoons. I left this beam in here, my support beam, that goes across, thinking I can get in there with the drill and drill it out where you can see the mess that I made. I made a huge mess. I am contemplating replacing that. It's not going to matter. It's not really going to move because once I have the plates on either side, it's not going to be able to move much. So, because this side's actually correct. I tried to take a shortcut and it didn't work out because I didn't want to take these beams out. But I was trying to go in like this and then get it in and get it leveled out. And it just threw my hole off by about a half inch. So, step back, punt, rethink it. And that's what I did. Learning as we go. Like I said, ain't nobody got a plans for how to build a boathouse out of scrap materials. Now, there's plenty of people on the internet that have tried it and failed. Because I took a few of them. There's this one guy down in Florida. And I just pray for the young man. He's a Christian. He's an older guy. He's like close to 70. And he takes these barrels in one piece, takes them out there and just throws them into water and then tries to build plywood around them, leaving the metal cages on. And then they stick out of the water like this high, like 3 feet before, actually 4 feet out of the water, bouncing, and he's trying to rig decking to it, and then the decking is actually bending up, so he's like this right here trying to put decking around these barrels. It's just too much buoyancy, and I would have done it, but I knew that was going to be the problem. I knew that, hey, that's way too much buoyancy. It's going to be sticking way too high out of the water, and the higher out of the water, the less stability you're going to have. If you got a real tall boathouse, it's going to be doing this, and that's going to be an issue that I may very well face, because if you can see, let me get around here and I'll show you. This 12 by 21 building, what I should have done, woulda, coulda, shoulda, but didn't. What I should have done was started small. I should have built this one right here, this 12 by 21. I should have built this, put it on the water, and had it making me money. I should have done that to begin with, but I wanted to make sure I did it big enough. I didn't want to cut corners. I should have went ahead and built this one, because this one could have taught me rights and wrongs, good and bad, up and downs. But you see how high this is from here. Okay, let me get my fancy tape measure and I'll show you. Mason, styrofoam's blowing everywhere because I asked you to put it up. Let me see here. I put my tape measure down, probably in the house. But my building's going to be 15 feet tall. That's a lot of height. That's really, really high out of the water. And I just pray, that when I do this, it ain't going to just flop over. That's a very big concern. More than likely, what I'll do is, with the second set of pontoons that are in the middle, I'll probably fill the center ones with water to make it like a ballast to hold it down. I may even go on the very corners, because this one down here is a corner post. This will be a corner here. But I may fill up the corners with water to keep it, keep weight on it. Told you guys yesterday about my problem about these things collapsing.
So if you're new to Targeted Citizen, let me just inform you of what exactly we're watching here, folks. So this is his this is his hillbilly arc that he's been working on ever since I've been watching him, at least, in years before. He never seems to make it past the pontoons. He's been getting all this lumber, all these videos we've watched him collecting scrap and stuff out at building sites, has all gone to this dream that he is going to build his own houseboat on homemade pontoons and sail off when the apocalypse comes, and I guess wait for Jesus out in the water somewhere. He's going to take the boy with him, which technically isn't his son. He hasn't said much about the wife, but anyways, or girlfriend, whatever the case may be. But that's what we're looking at. We're looking at basically ground zero of the hillbilly arc. I'm going to skip up a little bit here, folks, where he just starts ranting about different bullshit.
It must be, you must be crazy. And I've got a little story to tell you about that today as well.
Here we go. Here we go.
But as you can see, this is where we're going. This is what we got. Probably just going to let this go. The plate's going to be on it. It's not going to have much wiggle room to move. And as well as having the plate butted here and the plate butted here, I'll have steel plates on the outside to hold them together, two from each pontoon, and probably some steel cross braces. But a little news that I heard today, I don't know if anybody heard last week of the Judd family, you know, Ashley, Winona, and their mother, the singers out of Nashville, Tennessee, pushed on the news last week that the matriarch of the family, the mother, Miss Judd, passed away.
Wait a minute, I want to put that back.
I watched an interview today with Ashley. Posted on the news last week that the matriarch of the family, the mother, Miss Judd, passed away from each pontoon, and probably some steel cross braces. But a little news that I heard today, I don't know if anybody heard last week of.
To be fair, this is an older video, a few days old, but he heard last week. His finger's on the pulse. Anyways.
The Judd family, you know, Ashley, Winona, and their mother.
Now, correct, I'm not a huge country expert here, folks, but isn't it the daughter and the mother is the singing group? There's not three of them. One of them is the mother, right? Am I wrong? Can someone out there? Anyways, folks.
The singers out of Nashville, Tennessee. Posted on the news last week that the matriarch of the family, the mother, Miss Judd, passed away I watched an interview today with Ashley Judd, and I always had a crush on her, but she's such a left-wing lunatic. I just don't want to meet her in hell, so I'm going to think about that one in a different light. She was on there, and she's talking about what actually happened to her mother is that her mother committed suicide. She was there with her mom. Her mom said, please stay. And she said, oh, I'm just going to go downstairs for a minute. From the time she went downstairs and came back up, her mother had already put a pistol in her mouth and killed herself. Ashley Judd then said, people just don't understand. When you got voices telling you you're not good enough, you got voices telling you that you'll never be good enough, voices telling you no matter what that you're worthless, and voices are telling you all the time that you need to just kill yourself. These voices just kept telling my mama she wasn't good enough. She just couldn't hang on until, and this goes to the sinner and the sinner's thought and Ashley Judd being a sinner. My mama just couldn't cut the voices off long enough.
Thanksgiving, stick me with a fork. I'm all done.
I'm sorry, Wilson has just donated $2 through Super Chat. Rip Naomi Judd.
Thank you, Wilson. So apparently there is three. I forgot about Ashley Judd or whatever her name is. She's, I guess, an actress or something. So, but I know it's two that did the singing. Anyway, it doesn't matter.
Until they put her in the Country Music Hall of Fame. So she's talking about her mother and her mental state. And, oh, God. I mean, it'd be okay if she'd have killed herself after they put her in the Country Music Hall of Fame. Now rewind.
Well, I'm sure.
He said, what should I do?
What the fuck, Postal? You better fucking believe it. Go, 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 go.
JL has just donated $1.99 through Super Chat. Ashley Judd, the actress, is the third Judd.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And, so I think it was... yeah, he's going to twist this a little bit. I'm pretty sure that she was probably just speaking to the irony that she took her life just before she was inducted. Not that, you know, if only she waited till after.
The voices in her head told her to do something? Dementia doesn't tell you to kill yourself. Paranoid schizophrenia doesn't come later in life. I'm telling you, they do this with technology. What's the best way to murder someone is get them to do it to themselves. And then there's no one to blame. Because then what? Oh, mental illness. Oh, if we just could have helped her in time. In time? What do you mean in time? Multi-millionaire country music singer, a famous country music singer. She didn't have the financial capabilities to go to the doctor and say, doctor, I'm hearing voices. Help me. Why? Why would that not work? Because... you take a pill for a physical symptom, something going on in your body, something in your body's malfunctioning. Your body is born with the innate need to survive, to grow, to thrive. Your body, when you're born from your mother, created by God Himself, who knows every hair on your head, your sense of survival should be the greatest sense in your body, and it truly is, but... when there's outside technology in your mind, technology telling you, you're worthless, kill yourself, nobody loves you, you've never accomplished anything, because guess what? Those are the same voices that killed my best friend, Joshua Holler, the same voices that killed my fiance, Heather Hefner, the same voices that had me at the end of a rope, the same voices that kill thousands.
JL donated $1.99 through Super Chat. Judd Apatow, the comedian, is not in the Judd family.
Folks, we got that cleared up. Thank you very, very much, JL. Folks.
There's a people a day in America that we want to blame on mental illness is technology, voice-to-skull weapons. Voice of God weapons. The same weapons they used in the Gulf War, where what? Where 10,000 Taliban troops heard Allah in their head say, disassemble your AK-47s, drop them on the ground, raise your hands up and surrender. 10,000 troops did it.
The people that create this technology brag, yeah, we can put voices in your head. Ha 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 ha! We can make you hear troop movements here. We can make you hear God over there. We can make you hear anything in your head. Isn't that so cool? And the audience claps with exuberance. Oh, yay, this is so fun. Look at all the people we're going to save in wars where we don't have to shoot them. We just drive them crazy and they'll shoot themselves. That's where we are in America today, where you can be killed with technology. That's why the Bible says to capture every thought. Capture every thought. And also it says to test the spirits. People always give my pastor a hard time because he said that all these diseases like autism and pretty much the diseases created by the vaccines, he said a lot of this stuff is spiritual in nature. Jesus didn't come to earth, see a sick man, and say, you need to go see a doctor and get medication for that. No, he cast the demon that created the dumbness or created the retardation that created the ailment in that person. Jesus cast that demon out. He didn't say, go get you a doctor. Matter of fact, the Bible says to what? Treat pharmakia as that of the sin of witchcraft. What? Pharmakia is witchcraft. Yeah. When they're putting something in your body to change it in one way or the other, that's as witchcraft to God, because you are a perfect temple. So you have to constantly flush your body out with the Spirit of God. Pray the blood of Jesus over you and your family. Every single day, put on the full armor of God. And I'm guilty of not doing that, because I'm telling you, they've been hitting me bad. It has been a struggle to get up every day, and because I, like I said, I got a routine of praying before I get out of bed, and it's been a struggle to keep doing that with all the disappointments that I've been under lately. It is hard to keep getting up and trying to be a good man. It has near been impossible. Checked the weather map today and didn't say any rain was coming, but now it's getting awful dark and cloudy, and I don't think my son wants to be cleaning up water. It's going to be in all these, but as you can see, this is it. So my condolences to the Judd family. Listen to the interview with Astra Judd talking about how her mother's talking about, you know, voices in my head telling me I'm not good enough. Voices tell me I need to kill myself. Voices. Schizophrenia does not come in when you're 70 years old. It doesn't. And look at the amount of people all around America and the world that are experiencing these voices. Out of the blue, one day they just go crazy. Not a hint of mental illness, but all at one time, they start hearing voices in their head. If you haven't looked, and here's a case that was in the media and that was got full-blown coverage, Aaron Alexis. Look up the Aaron Alexis Navy Yard shooter, and that'll tell you all you need to know. Where he knew of the weapons, he had the classification to go into any Navy Yard in America. He had that clearance to do that. And before he went back and shot that place up, he carved my ELF extra low frequency weapon. He carved that in his rifle. He told many people about the voices in his head, and he told them exactly where it was coming from. It was coming from that Navy Yard base. What did he learn? What did he find out that he shouldn't have known? Or were they just experimenting on him like they do other targeted individuals like me? If your friend or family all at one time starts hearing voices, reach out to me immediately. When you take your family member to the doctor, they're going to put it on medicine. What's the side effects of that medicine say? It says suicidal thoughts or tendencies. That's what it says on all antidepressants. Any medicine that's supposed to alleviate voices in your head, the same medicine with the ones that stop the ringing in your ears, the same medicine, the side effects of all that is suicidal thoughts and tendencies. So before you make that fatal flaw, that fatal mistake of trusting your family members with a doctor, watch my videos, have them watch it, and have them listen to what I'm saying before they go and risk their lives. Because I'm telling you, I've experienced it, and I've lost people in my heart and in my life close to me, so close that I cut them down from the very rope they murdered themselves on. This is technology. And more people are going to be killing themselves and killing others as this technology with cell phones and everything else starts going on.
If 5G, folks. So just so we're clear, just so we're all up to date, folks, if you have a loved one, friend, or family member that you suspect may be slipping down that slippery slope of dementia, before you even entertain the idea of getting medical expertise involved, sit your loved one down in front of YouTube and have them watch this guy's videos. Because if they weren't confused before, I'm sure they will be after. Folks,
like all these satellites being manipulated, be very weary of what's happening. I'm Stuart Pidlong, the most targeted citizen. I'm getting ready to get wet. We're going to go pick up cans in the rain. Pray for me. Pray for my family. Pray for your purpose. I always pray in Jesus' name. God bless. Have a great day.
We'll be right back after these messages.
So, I was just up this morning just making my coffee, seeing how all these pregnant women are running out of baby formula because, the Great Tribulation, and, telling y'all how the prophecies are coming to pass, and I am the only one who could save y'all, when all of a sudden someone left a comment saying, Teela, you made it on Saturday Night Live. I was like, what? What the fuck? What are you? So I went to check, and I was like, what the fuck? Hold on, bro. At the 1:30 mark, so we'll start at 1:17 here. Apparently I am in Baby Yoda's crew, and we are obviously not from the earth. We're aliens, I guess, in a spiritual awakening on Baby Yoda on a spiritual awakening on Saturday Night Live. I guess God is, I don't know what's going on. But I'm like, what the fuck? Because I done left your planet so many thousands of years ago. I went into training, to become the mighty warrior assassin that I am. And I guess God is preparing me to arise now, because I'm telling you guys, that's why all the baby milk's running out. Everybody is just like in the outer darkness, because I told you I'm Joseph. And soon God is going to... he's preparing y'all for my arrival, for my return, and it's going to be a big comeback, because I'm not just coming back like some regular, look, it's Tia Tequila. I'm coming back as the Lord. I'm coming back as the Bride of Jesus. So, but anyways, for now, I guess I'm hanging out with Yoda and Jared Leto. Anyways.
We'll be right back after these messages.
America! Hey! I don't give a fuck, YouTube.
Yeah, baby, what's up, YouTube? Rocking that Gothic King Cobra, Green Cobra t-shirt, yeah. You don't have to buy the merch, but it's greatly appreciated. Just tuning in to watch the videos enough. We are going to be cooking up a deep fried burrito. Oh, it's going to be dank. We're going to have cheese, beef, bacon, some mango candy, jalapenos. Oh yeah, it's gonna be good. I tried making this last night, but I burnt the crap out of my burrito, so I'm like, screw it. I'll just redo the recipe tomorrow. Even Chef Gordon Ramsay has to do a couple retakes from time to time. That's just how it happens, man.
No!
So I'm not gonna beat myself up over it too much. We're just gonna reattempt it. Like, by the time I got done making the burrito, underneath
G-Man
that burnt smell, I could smell
G-Man
the actual
now.
Burrito. It's...
I'm sorry, Wilson donated $5 through Super Chat. I bet Tila won't look up the footage of her getting pelted with human shit when she tried performing in front of a crowd of juggalos.
That would be interesting. Interesting. Thanks, Wilson.
Self, and it smelled really good. Try not to burn it this time. Keyword is try. Now, I try to variety my cooking skills with different recipes. Cobra's Cafe, take a bite out of your hunger. I'd have Coke and Pepsi products on tap. I'd have lots of beer to choose from. Thirsty Thursdays, you come in, get a pitcher of beer with your favorite soda pop mixed in with it for like $6. Yeah, buddy. All right, YouTube. Let's grab our Mountain Dew. Let's grab the camera. Let's make it happen, Captain. Here's that badass skillet that my lesbian fan sent me. Greatly appreciate that. And the old skillet is right here. That's going to be going up for sale here one of these days. And all 100% of the proceeds from this auction, when I auction off this.
So this is obviously an older video. This is from his last apartment. But do you guys notice all the finger marks of the grease? That's back when he used to eat the grease. He'd get all drunk.
Pan on eBay. 100% of the proceeds are going towards a charity to help feed starving people. So it's a great way for one of my lucky fans to get their hands on some official King Cobra memorabilia and also do something great for the community. Now, when I went to Walmart yesterday with my dad to get some lawn supplies, he bought me a little bit of groceries to carry me through until I get my YouTube money, so that's greatly appreciated. There we go, one beef patty. So what are we doing right now, YouTube? We are making a deep fried burrito. Bacon, cheese, candied jalapenos, Doritos, beef. It's gonna be delicious. Go ahead and grab a spoonful and just plop it into our pan here. Like that. That'll give us some flavor profile for our burger. Throw a sprinkle of that on top. Seasoned side down first. Put it into that butter pile. Into that butter puddle right there. We'll sprinkle that on top. All right. Now all that butter, okay, don't grab this handle while it's on the stove. That's a little warm. Just a little spoonful like that. And we're gonna drop it on top of the burger.
I need G-Man, someone get a hold of G-Man now!
J-Skull donated $5 through Super Chat. The descent into drunken madness Kobe's has fallen into since 2013 is coming in nicely.
Yeah,
very. G-W-U.
That's what's up indeed. Now, I know we got Mud Broker out there, and he is if you don't know, he is an expert of all things cast iron. And I've heard of seasoning a skillet, but if you folks notice the seasoning going on the side of this the stove, it's got some country crock. Anyways, let's keep going.
There we go. So now he waits. Sit here and
you said, what should I do?
You better fucking believe it. Go, 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 go.
I'm sorry, Wilson has just donated $2 through Super Chat. Mudbrooker, this how a real man cooks in cast iron.
Yep, you taking some notes?
Pour a splash of Mountain Dew on top of our burger patty.
Ooh, some Mountain Dew, country crock.
There we go. Mountain Dew has like citrus and lemon, you know.
Shout out to Boglum Chronicles for this video. This is one of, I guess his, there. Well, it's an edit from that channel.
Kind of but you were like citrus, lime, lemon, you know. Lemons and limes. Lemons and limes are sometimes used in Mexican cooking. So a little bit goes a long way, just a little bit to flavor that beef. Yeah, buddy. And we're gonna give this burger patty a flip. Oh, ho, 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 yeah, baby. Yeah, buddy.
Keeping it on nice medium heat is actually a smart idea. I should have done that last night. But that's part of cooking, YouTube, I guess. You know, you'll learn a thing or two. If you're gonna grab a hot skillet pan handle like this, grab like a washcloth and use that to like, you know. So what I'm doing right now is just kind of going like that. I want to cut the beef patty into chunks to make it fit the burrito better. Yeah, that's enough grease for our pan to cook up our bacon. Just look at it. Yeah, I might throw a splash of butter in there while the bacon's cooking up. So now we got our two pieces of bacon right here. What I'm gonna do is we're gonna tear them in half. So now we got four smaller pieces. YouTube, we got my hands washed, dried off. Look at that bacon just sizzling up in the pan. Oh my god, that looks good. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna add some seasoning to our bacon. Look at that. Boom, show that logo. So we're gonna sprinkle a little bit under our applewood smoked bacon that's also thick cut. Just a little bit. This is basically candied bacon seasoning, is what it's supposed to be used for. So if you're making candied bacon in the oven, you use this stuff to sweeten it up a little bit. So we're gonna sprinkle it just a little bit onto our bacon here. And if a little bit of this sweet bacon rub gets into the grease, that's all right, because we're gonna be frying this burrito up in it anyways. Do like a little sprinkle of it onto the bacon here. Perfect. Just a little bit. Right in there. Look at that. You see where the bacon rubs on there? Right where I sprinkled it. Beautiful. All right. Oh yeah, that bacon is fully cooked. You know what? Yeah, I think that's enough grease to fry up our burrito. Let's start off with our two tortilla shells. These are the carb balance tortillas, high in fiber, new look and same great taste. On 100 years of quality, show that logo. Not a sponsor. Like I said, I have two tortilla shells. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna microwave it so that the tortilla shells stick to each other just a little bit. We want nice, soft tortilla shells. We're going to just break it up into chunks. You don't have to be pretty with it because it's all going to go into your stomach anyway, so you really don't have to be that pretty with it. Just take the beef and break it up into chunks. Again, just take that bacon, break it up into small pieces. Or smaller pieces, I should say. Put it right on top there. Ooh-wee. So now what we're gonna do, add some cheese to the top of that beef and bacon right there. Yeah. Yeah. And we're gonna take a pinch of that cheese and we're gonna sprinkle it on top of our beef and bacon. Now the trick to rolling a good burrito is to not overstuff it. If you overstuff the burrito, it's going to fall apart, and you're not going to be able to enjoy very much of it. You're going to have to end up eating it with a fork, and that's never any fun. So like a nice little sprinkle, and one more little sprinkle of that cheese on top. There we go, beautiful. All right, so I want to take, kind of push it down just a little bit, flatten it out. There we go. Oh boy, these mango candied jalapenos. We're gonna take our candied mango jalapenos. And it goes without saying, we're gonna add a little bit of crunch to our deep fried burrito. Four or five will do it. First of all, I wanna kinda push this down a little bit. There we go. And then once you fold the sides in, you wanna take and roll it. I'm gonna try to do it from this side so you can watch me roll it. Okay, and then you take one side here and kinda, this is where it gets tricky. Ooh. I have to take some of these Doritos off to make room. Haha. And I'm just gonna roll it, push it down. On tuck. And once you got that in there, kind of, I know it can be difficult to fold sometimes. I'm trying really hard here, YouTube, to make this. I really am. No, you don't. Don't come unfolded. Fuck me. Do not come unfolded, please. No. Don't do that. Oh boy. No, goddamn you, don't fucking, oh, you piece of fucking shit. Oh my god, we're so close to making it. I got this, YouTube. And it fell apart. I just want to fucking cry, dude. God fucking damn it. Not only did it come unrolled. Suck my dick with this, dude. Fuck! Well, that looks a lot better than my last attempt, I'll tell you that right now. At least it re-rolled, that's a good thing. God. Well, that's as good as it's gonna get, YouTube. That's not perfect by any means, but you know what? I'll take it. A lot of my fans right now are probably at work, and this is helping them pass the workday along nicely. I'm serious though, if you ever come to Casper, Wyoming and you want a damn good burrito, you go to Poncho's. Huh? Now, my favorite thing to get at Poncho's is the California burrito, but I have them custom make it for me. You get the California burrito with everything on it. You add beef, bacon, extra cheese, and guacamole. All right, now I'm looking at it. I'm like, it looks good and it smells good. My only complaint is that it came unrolled in the pan when I was trying to fry it up. So we'll see how it turned out. Uh-huh. Oh my. Oh, hold up. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Hell yeah. It's a cross section. My only complaint though is I kind of wish that the tortilla would have been a little bit more crispy, but beggars can't be choosers. I call it a success. Anyways, YouTube, I do appreciate you all tuning in to watch this here cooking video. If you like the cooking videos, subscribe for more. I'll catch you, cool cobras, later. Ha ha ha, yeah.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Finish him!
Yeah! Hoopee!
Fatality.
Wins.
Hey, everybody. So.
First time I uploaded a video, I was scared to death. But Kajabi made it easy to face my fear, so I could...
So there are a lot of people who are on the fence about getting involved in the sport of boxing, or you were involved at one point and you've taken a little break and maybe need a boost to get back into it. So in this video, I'm going to discuss 10 reasons why I think you should get involved in the sport of boxing. Now, first, before we get into the 10 reasons, check out my Boxing is the Best Training for Real Life t-shirts. I partnered with Victory Fightwear. For the first 10 orders that come through, any of those individuals will be...
All right, so we don't need to sit through all this bullshit. But Nick Bravo apparently is thinking about getting into boxing. Now, I don't know what's going on out there. Maybe someone can fill me in. Why he directed this video at just Darren. I don't know if they got a beef going on or if they're talking about getting training together. I don't know. But he watches these boxing videos. And we're going to skip up a little bit because we don't need to listen to all this bullshit about boxing. But it's interesting when... Now, what you have to understand about Nick, and he's made it very public, folks, that his preference in a woman is one that will dominate over him. He loves extraordinarily athletic women, weightlifters, superheroes, and he has an active fantasy of getting the hell beat out of him by one of these Amazonian women, right? It's funny, he never mentions Wonder Woman much. Anyways, I digress. What I found particularly interesting is how involved and engaged Nick Bravo got when he started watching the women boxing. We'll check that out in a minute. Let's skip up ahead.
Size or muscle growth.
And people who don't know jack shit go, oh, you're an expert. No, no, it's just no. That's not how it works.
I've seen my self-defense video. It's not self-defense in the way you might think.
Oh, Darren has, he challenged Nick. Okay, so Nick is now showing everybody he is training. He has begun the training. He has started looking at YouTube videos about training. So, that's where we're at, apparently.
Thing. But first of all,
the hell is happening? They're getting trucked across the street. They're like, what the hell is going on? What do I do? What's going on? They just start screaming and they're freaking out, right? And that's what happens when you're not prepared for a fight. And unfortunately, you know, sometimes violent criminals will attack you as you're walking. They'll attack you from behind. They'll assault you. They'll drag you across the street. You know, and, you know, there might not be people there who are able to, you know, save your ass. Who knows? You know, I mean, seriously. So being able to, like, box and do martial arts, you know, have that kind of thing to where you're like, okay, I know how to defend myself, but you also got to have the physical strength. I know it's fun to watch these shows where these, like, women who are, like, fucking 5 foot, 100 pounds can take on the 6'5", 300-pound guy with one or two punches. That's not reality. That's not how reality works. If your opponent is quite a bit bigger than you or in a lot better shape, you're going to have to fight that much harder. But if you're panicking, you're not going to be able to have, you're not going to have a chance to collaborate.
Someone get a hold of G-Man now!
I'm sorry, Wilson donated $5 through Super Chat. I've heard it firsthand. Nick Bravo wants Honey Badger to drag his ass across the street next.
He probably would not reject that idea. Don't put it out there, right? So Nick Bravo is probably one of the last guys you want to listen to about self-defense advice. Except I will stick up for Nick with this. When it comes to the example that he gave about the 5 foot woman beating up a 6 foot five man, I trust he has put a lot of thought, right? And just he's crunched the numbers, folks, on what it takes for a woman to beat up a man. I do believe that.
Dan donated £1.99 through Super Chat.
Oh, thank you very much, Dan. I appreciate that. All right, on with the show here, folks.
In reality.
confident. And so boxing puts you in a state of mind that's going to give you greater awareness, greater self-confidence, and it's going to eliminate a self-defense situation before it even occurs. You're going to be proactively eliminating situations that would have to lead to self-defense.
Yep.
One thing I like about boxing is that
Oh, Nick agrees. You know what the funny thing is? Nick, the side-by-side, I just want to tell you, when Nick looks in the mirror, it's this guy that Nick sees, I think, sometimes. It's, anyways.
It is for everybody. If you can, let's say you put your hand up, if you can do this, if you can do that, you can box. If you can do this, move around with your feet,
yep,
you can box. If you can do this, you can box. So whether you're 70 or you're just somebody who thinks that they don't belong in the sport of boxing, I say to erase that sort of thinking. Give it a shot before you make any conclusions. Boxing, as long as you are in.
All right.
It's like two punches, right?
Here we go.
I did a punch and a punch and then a finger strike to his throat. And I literally felt my finger like right up on his trachea.
All right, you got to back this up a bit.
Right? It's been a black belt for like, so.
I want to get this whole story. I want to get this whole story.
Move around with your feet.
Yep.
You can box. If you can do this, you can box. So whether you're 70 or you're just somebody who thinks that they don't belong in the sport of boxing, I say to erase that sort of thinking. Give it a shot before you make any conclusions. Boxing, as long as you are in structurally decent condition. You don't have any serious injuries in your neck or in your hips or shoulders, nothing too serious, then you can box. Boxing is for everybody. Number 9, through boxing, you build a lot of friendships, a lot of camaraderie. There is almost no greater camaraderie you can build than sparring with someone and elevating each other to that level, especially if you're sparring with somebody you know and somebody you trust. That is some real companionship right there. And as one boxer that I had sponsored put it in a different way that I'd never thought of before, boxing builds trust. When you're with somebody else in the ring, you have to trust that they're going to put on their best performance, but in a clean and ethical way, you have to trust that somebody is there.
So when I was living with my dad in Idaho, I was actually taking Taekwondo classes. And this was when I was in my 20s. Birth father demanded that I not be in it eventually because what I did was so when we were sparring, we would spar with other students and we would spar with our instructors, right? I still don't understand how I did it so quickly. My instructor was surprised. This instructor was like, had been a black belt for like fucking 25 years, old Mexican guy, tough as nails, fucking badass, right? When I sparred, I did this like, because we were supposed to do like 3 strikes. We were supposed to do like a finger strike in there plus like 2 punches, right? I did like a punch and a punch and then a finger strike to his throat. And I literally felt my finger like right up on his trachea. His eyes got so big. He was like so fucking proud of me. And at some point, I guess he told my dad or whatever. And my dad was like, instead of my father being proud, it was like, yep, you're not going to be in Taekwondo anymore. I was just like, what the fuck, right? I almost want to start crying, tearing up about that shit. I mean, it's just like, fuck. What if I would have stuck with Taekwondo?
I can't help but feel that there's a lot more to that story, folks. What do you guys think out there? Do you think there's a little bit more to this story? That he was just pulled out of Taekwondo? His instructor was so proud that he had to have a talk with his father after, and they decided at best that Corky be pulled from the class. It sounds like he struck an instructor to me, but
for like, you know, fucking 20 years, I'd be a black belt by now. Shit, you know? And that's the thing of it. It's like, you know, but at the same time, it's like,
I need G-Man. Someone get a hold of G-Man now. You...
Baptized in Fire donated $4.99 through Super Chat. Here is the one thing I have learned in all my years in martial arts. It's a must to learn to fight on the ground, cause all fights will end up there.
That is good advice, and thank you very much, folks.
Harm don't want you to be athletic. They don't want you to know how to fight. They don't want you to know how to defend yourself. And that's, you know, being able to defend yourself, it's a necessity, really. And unfortunately, more so in these days than any other, it seems like. So back to you.
Here to help you and look out for you. You have to trust that somebody wants the best for you and that you want the best for them.
In reality.
They can.
Here we go. Engaging. Nick, what? How is it that you haven't hit 1,000 subscribers yet? It'll escape me with this type of engaging content, folks.
And, no, it's dishwashing. And, I'm just gonna fucking show up in my fucking shorts and t-shirt. I'm not gonna wear this, obviously, but I'm just getting a little fucking, exhausted with it. He's basically like, make sure you sweep the floors and walk in the bathroom. That's fine. I plan to do that. That's fine. It's but what these people will do is they will literally bring me all the dirty dishes. And then they're gone. They take off. As soon as they get all their shit done, they take off. He's telling me.
Well, as I understand it, though, Nick, maybe I'm wrong. Someone, again, correct me if I'm wrong, folks. But isn't his job being the dishwasher? He just said he's going to be. And he's like, well, my first problem is people keep bringing me dirty dishes as well. Nick, I'm pretty sure that's the role of the dishwasher. Anyways,
you have to leave at the same time as the cooks. Well, if I don't have the dishes done. And they're giving me so few hours to begin with. It's like, wait, what? Yeah. He's pushing. He is pushing. Anyway. Yeah, again, it goes back to, I honest to God don't even want to fucking. I honest to God don't even. I mean. See, this is what I mean. Now I'm thinking about fucking work. I don't even have to be there for a fucking another hour, and I'm already thinking about it. It's like, fuck you people. I'm not gonna fucking unionize. That's stupid. Anyway. No, what I need to do is I need to let's see here. We're gonna watch another video. We're gonna watch another video. I'm just tired of getting pushed. Honest to God. Honest to fucking God. It's like holy fucking shit, you know.
So from this point on, Nick proceeds to start watching various women's boxing, which is fine. But again, we know what Nick's... I don't think he's watching this for the sport. Which is whatever, but it's interesting. It's interesting knowing Nick's preferences with large athletic women that he wishes that they will dominate and beat him up. That is his, this is his words, not mine. I mean, everybody's got their own thing. I'm not saying it's bad. I'm just saying it's interesting watching him watch this. Folks, I hope the kids are in bed.
Let's do this. This watch this. This is pretty hot.
Except
for the tattooed one.
For you, round number one.
I hate Black fucking tattoos. You put tattoos on your neck. I'm sorry, you're trash. That's just my opinion. Especially the fucking lips.
I'm someone get a hold of G-Man now.
I'm sorry, Wilson donated $5 through Super Chat. Honest answer. Nick Bravo versus Cyrax in a boxing match. Who bitches out first when they get clocked in the face?
You know, I think I would give it to Nick. I think he would get his a confidence streak. I think he would but I think that he might be a little intimidated just because of the attitude of Cyrax. I think coming in, if Nick can get over the initial hurdle of Cyrax, he's kind of like that yippy little dog at the door. And then when Nick realizes he can just kick him out of the way, I think Nick will be all right. Nick will be all right.
Seriously.
Stepping into the pocket and trading. Big shots now. And Rawlings opening up. Countering right back goes Garcia.
I can't stand looking at this woman because she's a bitch. So I'm going to.
I get it.
24 minutes. Beck Rawlings.
Count
from Bill Clancy.
I'm sorry, I can't stand watching that. Anyway, because she's grotesque. She's ugly.
Oh, well, why are you watching it?
Fugly.
Why are you watching it, Nick?
She's fugly.
Oh, let's see what he picks.
Fugly. I don't want to look at fugly women. Sorry. This is hot. This might be hot. Commercial. Godforsaken commercial that nobody wants to see. She's hot. She's fucking pretty hot.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the judges are ready. The fighters are ready. We need to know, Biloxi, Mississippi, are you ready? Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. She weighed in at 170 pounds and wears tonight the
ooh, red, white, let's blue. Go, Vonda. Her record, damn, Ohio. That's kind of close to where I am.
She has 18 victories, 15 of those by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, from Northfield, Ohio, she is the current IBA heavyweight champion of the world. Here is Vonda, the All-American Girl War.
I just want to point out that every black and Latina chick that he glazed over, he's like, she's around, but then when we have the fucking Aryan ideal, an absolute monolith of fucking blonde hair, white skin, the all-American girl, look at the look on his face, man. He's right sitting forward. He's like a fucking, folks.
Fighting out of the blue corner.
Nick is gonna love it.
I don't find torching that interesting.
Her trunks tonight, black and gray.
The boss is like fucking. The boss thinks she's fucking funny.
16 victories, just one defeat, and 11 big wins by way of knockout.
Is it okay, just what the fuck is this shit? A three belt holder
as we speak. She holds the WIBC middleweight championship, the WIBA and IFBA super middle championship, and tonight. She looks to become the first woman in the history of boxing to hold four titles at one time. From Austin, Texas, here is Ann Brown Sugar. Again, your referee in charge of the action. Final instructions.
All right, ladies, you received your instructions a little while ago. I so met both of you in the dressing room. Remember the two things that I said. One, when I take a safe break, take a first step back.
I'm about ready to box up my boss. That's what I'm fucking saying. God damn, she is fucking.
Now. Come out, boxer. Elmo hurt his head looking up at
shit.
Six.
Shit.
Find the ward.
And Elmo's wearing his elevator.
God damn. Fuck.
Well, if there's a post fight interview with her. With Vonda, I'm glad you'll be doing it.
Sorry, folks. I'm looking at Vonda, very and I'm just like fucking salivating.
And Vonda Ward.
Damn, She's fucking hot.
Oh, nice left hook already by Ann Wolf.
I didn't catch how tall she is.
That first right hand, and there's another one.
I didn't catch how tall she is.
Vonda. And I think when Vonda, like I said, gets hit with the first real power shot, we'll see how she reacts to it. She's sticking her chin up in the air, but it's so high up in the air, it's almost at the top of this Mississippi Coast Coliseum.
You got to swing one of those overhand rights way over, like trying to do there. Ann Wolf with a right hand. She says her best punch is that left hook. She says in the ring, I'm a brawler puncher.
You see, Vonda a little tentative, though. I think she's already taken a little bit of the power. She is making
I wonder if she's going to see this big page.
That Rodney Phillips, that she's sticking the chin up. Nice combination by backing Vonda up.
It is difficult to ascertain how Vonda has done it.
Come on.
15 oh,
you mean she?
Fight her.
The other one won. Oh, come on! Come on! How the fuck she get knocked out? Oh, she's knocked out. She's knocked out. She's done. God damn it!
Unbelievable. Let's hope.
I honestly think Vonda's better looking, but.
That is probably the best knockout punch I've ever seen in boxing.
Absolutely.
Ever.
Still on the canvas, Vonda Ward.
Wow.
Damn. Well, shit. That fucking sucks. Vonda Ward. Okay, we're gonna see what she's doing. Let's see what she's doing, 1973. Oh, whoa, she's like a year younger than I am. She's 6'7". God damn. Fucking hell. What's she doing now? Retirement, 2010. Personal trainer working out at King's Gym, Bedford, Ohio. None forgiven back to her community. I'm going to Bedford, Ohio, motherfuckers. I'm gone. Goodbye. I'm off to Bedford, Ohio. I gotta meet Vonda. Shit. 6'7"? Ah, damn. Holy fuck. Well, 6'6", it says, but anyway, heavyweight shit. Anyway. Sad thing is she's probably married. She's probably married. No, she's a year older than I am. 49. Shit. God damn. Ooh. Oh, god damn. Oh, she's married. She's got a fucking kid. So she's married. It's like, damn it. See, I can't go for women my own age. I have to go for the women who, I can't go for women my own age. I can't go for women my own age. I literally have to fucking, yeah, she got cut down looking. That's sad, but true. Yeah, she got knocked down pretty quick. I was kind of surprised. I was like, what the fuck? Anyway. Nah, he's just trying to feel important. Anyway. I gotta work on my book and I gotta work on this stuff. I've got my gym membership. I need to fucking. She doesn't seem that attractive. I couldn't tell how tall she was. It didn't say. I gotta close the window. She like five. If she's my height, then you know that can work. That can work. So I have asked Darren where he lives. And, you know, if there's a boxing ring around where he lives and I can train.
What do you think, guys? Should we get this going? Can we feature this? This could be like a year ender, a main event at this year's year in review before I announce the Golden Lulzcow winner. That's another thing, folks. We got to get down to business here, and I'm serious. If you can see me right now, I'm actually tapping the table. And when I tap the table, that means I'm serious. We got to start putting our ducks in a row here for the you know, next thing we know, the season will be towards the end, and we'll be like, well, who is deserving of this year's Golden Lulz cow? And right now we're in a Lulz lull. It's a little bit of a lull going on. Now, I'm sure, like I said, this is the calm before the storm. There's going to be good times to come, but folks, we got to seriously start narrowing it down. Who this year is in the running for the top three? The top three at least, folks. Folks. Anyways, we'll skip through this and move on here.
And then we can do the whole, like, live stream the boxing match. That'd be fun.
Let's
be
do fun, it. Wouldn't it. We should do it.
Won't folks. It? I think it'd be fun.
I'll host it. Live.
2050, another middle-aged man, probably older than I am. What's with all these old people coming out of the woodwork to give me shit? I just don't understand it. I really don't. I really don't. La, 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 la. So we're going to sit here and let's see. I'm going to look at more boxing stuff. Where is the, let's see. And she's like,
yeah, boxing stuff.
Hmm.
Yeah, boxing videos. That's what he's interested in now, folks.
Best of women.
Here we go.
You might have to, I understand look, you might be.
Look at the smile on his face. He liked this one, I remember. This one is right from, well, let's see.
This is him. He's going to wake up from a blackout and wonder why the fuck he did that. Because it's going to be live streamed. And, you know, here's part of the problem. I think a lot of these guys, they see the Timmy shit. They're like, well, Timmy easily knocked Nick down and drug him across the street and blah, blah, blah. No, never mind the fact that Nick was not trying to fight. He was just trying to get away. Never mind the fact that Nick was completely out of his testosterone. Never mind the fact that Nick was physically fucking
weak. I need
weak,
G-Man, someone get a hold of
G-Man. Because he hadn't
G-Man
had
now.
Any fucking decent food or anything.
JL donated $4.99 through Super Chat. I'm already fat and on the verge of a heart attack. Pretty sure I could get in even worse shape to fight Corky.
Nice. We'll keep that in mind.
Something like that. We're going to ignore all those facts, and we're going to pretend that it was a fair fight. No. We're also going to ignore the fact that, you know, I had a probation officer tell me that I don't care if somebody's trying to assault you or stalking you. If you fell back, that's a stop, and that's a piss.
I need G-Man. Someone get a hold of G-Man now.
I'm sorry, Wilson donated $5 through Super Chat. To defend the honor of my fellow Buckeye, I'll agree to box Nick. If he wins, he gets Vonda. If I win, he has to box Vonda. Have fun with that, Nick.
Actually, he would. See, that's a win-win for Nick, actually. That's very gracious of you.
It's like, okay. I don't know what else to say. The Black Onion dude. The fuck? The Black Onion. Darren, I don't want to know about your gangrenous testicles. I understand you might be, your testicles might be a bit gangrenous. Maybe you should see a doctor instead of, you know, I'm just saying. Oh, let's see. I am not sad. Let my fist do the talking. That's right. Got to do my fist in talking. Let my fist in talking. The problem is it has to be a sanctioned. It has to be a sanctioned fucking boxing match. That way, when I knock Darren's ass down, he can't pull out his phone and be like, please, somebody made me look like a dumbass. you know, I don't want to, you know, it has to be a sanctioned match, right? That's why I'm not going to fucking show up in somebody's backyard, because I don't know what state he's in even. I suspect, but if it's the state that I suspect, they have stand your ground laws. So yeah, that's a bad thing. Unfortunately, that's a bad thing. Let's watch some more daddy. Oh my God.
In a woman's MMA, it's unusual to see a fight above 145 pounds, let alone a true heavyweight matchup.
Ah! Fuck this shit.
But Ryzen, a Japanese promotion, made it happen in 2016 God. With a matchup of absolutely massive proportions. In one corner stood 6'2", 245-pound former grappling champion Gabby Garcia, while on the other was the 5'9", 227-pound pro football running back Destiny Yarbrough.
You said, what should I do?
The fight started out with hesitant exchange.
You better fucking believe it. Go, 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 go!
JL has just donated $1.99 through Super Chat. If I die in the ring, my stepson will avenge me.
Nice, nice. Okay, sounds good. We'll see if we can set it up. Look at this guy. Look at Corky is in his glory right now. But he's watching it totally for technique, folks. This is all study purposes for training. Remember how this video started? Remember how it started?
Is on the feet between the two.
Look at him.
But then Garcia was able to drag her opponent to the canvas, where she's much more comfortable. From there, Garcia tired Yarbrough up with punches and even a knee to the head before showing her Brazilian jiu-jitsu skills by setting up an American submission, going into the full mount to force Yarbrough to tap.
God damn. She's just...
In December 2016, Garcia faced a Japanese pro wrestler in Saitama, Japan. Garcia was 8 inches taller, 18 years younger, and approximately 40 pounds heavier than her opponent. Not to mention that she was a proven fighter. The Japanese started the fight in total pro wrestling fashion. Garcia, however, appeared to be confused, but had had enough by the time Hada hit the ropes for the
I'm
third
like
time
a stuffed
and turned
turkey
for the fourth.
For
she grabbed her and
stick me with a fork. I'm all done.
I'm sorry, Wilson has just donated $2 through Super Chat. JL, I'll avenge you, stepdad.
All right, we got it going on, folks. Look, he is like two videos. Yeah, there's something going on here. There's a he is loving. He is just in his look at him. He is in a complete state of bliss watching this woman manhandle. If I can use that expression, another woman.
Began battering her with punches and knees. It has nothing to do with mastery or technicality. It was just a larger, stronger woman hammering a grandmother.
Right hand to referee says that.
Yeah, that's not. Yeah, I don't know what the fuck that was. That was just embarrassing.
Gabby Garcia has been generally successful in her transition from Brazilian jiu-jitsu to MMA.
Equals.
However, in July 2017, she took
to
a bold
do.
Step forward by making
find.
Her boxing debut against a veteran mixed
but
martial
for God's
arts fighter.
Sakes,
as expected,
like,
Garcia's
shit.
Size and power were way too much for the 45-year-old opponent.
What the fuck?
The Japanese got tripped up along the ropes and then struck with an illegal soccer kick after being repeatedly pounded with body strikes.
Garcia's fucking heavier. Why would you put
Garcia was
right?
issued a warning from the referee, and
the
action
Japanese
was reset.
Clearly,
but less than a minute later, the Japanese were turned and dropped to a knee by a punch and received yet another soccer kick.
God damn it.
This one, however, landed cleanly
no,
and put her down
God.
On the canvas for good, and the fight was ruled a no contest. In July 2017,
right.
Garcia.
We're just going to have Corky breathing heavy in the microphone here in a minute.
He's a Russian boxer at Ryzen 6 in Saitama, Japan. The fight in.
Wait. You see Gabby. She's
like. Oblique kick again.
Look at him.
I will wrestle Amazons. I will.
There's a train left again. Still everywhere. She's trying to get drunk.
you can no. Again, Holly has, and she's like, showing it here. One in with a big shot. She's
oh, this is fucking hot.
His chin God is up. Damn. Nice leg kick. Again, ducks under. And Holly Holm is taking down Ronda.
I like watching lionesses score.
But she did it anyway.
Oh, there you go. Shot back up, though, Joe. Got right back up.
Gliding up her legs. And she's catching her as one.
Takes a lot of energy to be a rock star.
Well,
and right now, Holly's taking a lot.
It has nothing to do with being a rock star. She's getting lit up.
And round one is in the books.
Big, no, big no,
round
no,
from Holly Holm. No. Huge round.
In all likelihood, that is the first round that Ronda has lost.
Oh, no doubt about it. Most of it we talked dumb. About. Again, John.
Oh, come on.
Again with that left hand.
What the hell was that?
Corky is at the climax of the match here. I'm going to skip ahead. Look at the look on his face. Someone get this man a cigarette, folks.
All Darren has to do is tell me where to live, and we can, you know, if there's a place to do boxing, if there's, you know, all that. I mean, you know, I've no problem with it. I do need to get trained for it, though. So I will also be looking for a boxing instructor. I'll say, yeah, there's this dirty old man by the name of Darren who's a pedo, and he's challenged me to a boxing match in some godforsaken state called whatever. So much fun. Anyway. No, it's not that way. It's not that way. No, if somebody, yeah, no, just because, man, what the fuck? I just noticed this like light on my fucking head. Anyway. It's so fucking funny. I do need to go because I am going to try to get a friend.
This video is a couple days old, 2 or 3 days old.
But you know, before I go to work, because I'm going to need it. And, la 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 la.
He's in the afterglow, folks. This is afterglow. This is Nick Bravo afterglow. Folks, let's move ahead here.
We'll be right back after these messages.
The Force is strong with you.
I am seriously sick of this shit, man.
Here is the path to the dark side. Whoa!
That's no moon.
There's more machine.
Successful, Nick!
Keep going, Nick! I can finally run it! Do it!
I didn't think you were gonna get rid of me that easily, did you?
May the Schwartz be with you.
It cleaned everything underneath the
Hey, is Chance here?
Yeah?
Someone called again.
Yeah, somebody called again. Come here.
Does he know who's calling, by chance? They don't leave their name or number or anything.
No, and they also use numbers that where you can get...
You good, Chance?
Yeah, I'm good.
Wow. Someone called and said you want to hurt yourself or something.
No.
What's going on?
These guys have been doing this shit for a while.
No. We try to get a number. We try to get a name and a number.
Yeah, the only guy that I know of is we're out in Massachusetts. Or not Massachusetts, but out of Milwaukee.
Okay.
He's the only one that I know of.
All right.
And this other guy, who he is, but he's the one that's been getting all the body cam footage of you guys and posting it up and harassing us with it.
Yeah.
All right, well, as long as you're good, man.
Now, someone's put out there that's been like 40 calls to the cops this year alone and da-da-da. I don't feel sorry for the cops because, to be fair to Cyrax, he's been telling the cops that there's people fucking with him on the internet for like a few years now, and no one will listen to him, and now the cops are like, yeah, they called again. Do you know who might be calling? Well, geez, I don't know. I gotta actually give Cyrax one on this. You know?
Yeah, I'm good, man. For sure.
All right. Take it easy.
Yeah,
you
too.
Yeah, thank you. This dude's crazy. People just, like, just try.
Marty, you want a pathetic little bitch coward? Look at you, you fucking ratty ass.
Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to play a song right now, and I'm going to do a live performance right in front of you, okay? So I'm going to do a live performance right in front of you. Let me pull up the lyrics here. 1 second. Hang on, Cyrax. Stay put. Okay. Okay. So far,
let me ask something, Marty. What makes you think you have the right to attack motherfuckers, you little bitch ass punk? Well,
I understand that this fat retard in New Zealand has probably gotten to your head, it's probably gotten to all your heads. So, let me ask you this. I'm gonna ask you this, Sarks, really quickly. You see my picture here? This woman claims that she had been neo-Nazi acid attacked. She's also claimed that she attempted suicide by gasoline. What is your theory, Cyrax?
Anything. You don't understand.
That's not an answer. It's a very specific question. Is it a bad chem peel? Is it a neo-Nazi acid attack? Or is it a gasoline suicide attempt? Like, why can't you pick one? You're a person who has a mind. Tony, you're here too.
You're hey, here Marty, too. Why don't you do yourself a favor and shut that hole in your face you call a fucking mouth?
No. So I have a question, a very specific question that has a 1, 2, or 3 answer. Okay. Tony, what do you think? Do you think this was a neo-Nazi biker attack with acid, a gasoline suicide attack, or a bad chem peel? What do you think, Tony?
Whatever happened that day, I don't know. We may never know.
Okay, so my question is,
but this. If I had to guess, Marty,
yeah,
since you're doing this for shits and giggles, yeah, I'm gonna say the obvious.
It's not for shits and giggles. It's because this fat lady in New Zealand won't leave me alone. She's sending up all of her pedophile simps, Ouija Loke, Tony, and Cyrax. Like, that's all the pedophiles are here.
Facts.
All the pedophiles
I'm not
here.
A pedophile. Neither is Cyrax, Marty.
He said he's a pedophile.
Get it through your head, Marty. I'm not a pedophile. Okay. I don't go after little girls.
Listen,
Marty.
I'm going to meet you guys, and I'm going to record a live album in front of the pedophiles. Here we go. Let's go. Let's do this thing. pedophiles. That's why
I'm not a pedophile.
That's because that's the reason you guys stay in cahoots. It's because you're all fucking pedophiles. There you go. Ask Ouija Loke why his wife left him. There you go. Because they're all fucking pedophiles. There you go. So here you go.
Like, Marty, let me ask you this. Where's your proof that I'm a pedo, bitch? You got none, nigga. You're a coward fuck boy who honestly needs a...
Hey, Tony, do you find anything wrong with Sarek sending his penis picture to a 14-year-old girl?
That's his business.
No, I'm asking
what Cyrex does is his business. What I'm telling you, Marty,
I'm asking you. Do you see anything wrong with Cyrex
sending... I'm not a pedophile, Marty.
Tony, I'm asking you. Do you see anything wrong with Cyrex sending his penis picture to a 14-year-old girl? If you can't answer that, then you are in the same league as Cyrex and Luigi Loke.
I'm not a pedophile.
So do you see anything wrong with Cyrex sending his penis picture to a 14-year-old girl?
Cyrax was set up.
Okay, but he took the bait. He took the bait and sent his penis to a 14-year-old girl, right, Tony? That's what happened. Hey, listen. It's funny that Jasmine, a retard, has got you so wrapped around your fingers that you have to come here and defend her.
Jasmine doesn't have me wrapped around her fingers.
Okay, so I'm gonna ask you guys both this here. Okay?
Jasmine knows who I am.
Okay, so I'm going to ask you guys this. Simple question. Neo-Nazi biker gas attack, suicide attempt, or bad chempeel? What do you guys think? Can you answer that? What do you think?
Marty, yeah. You're a fucking pussy. You're a bitch, man, nigger boy. You're one, a fucking pussy, bro.
One, two, or three. Because I know what's going on here. One, two, or three. One, two, or three. Pick one. It's a simple number. Answer.
Something. Let me ask you something first, motherfucker.
One, two, or three, Tony. One, two, or three.
I gave you my answer, Marty.
What's that?
Number three. And if Marty, it was I'll up to me. Answer,
bad chempeel, right? Yeah, that's okay. So what type of sick person would lie about a suicide attempt or a gasoline?
No, okay. Somebody from the private chat wants to know how I got my PTSD. You know how I got my PTSD? I was picked on by girls. I was used. You know how I was used? I almost got my ass kicked in middle school, in high school, because girls would take advantage of me. That's how I got my PTSD. There, you happy now? That's how I got it.
So I would think that if it was a gasoline suicide attempt, that
surely... it'd be all over her face.
Yeah, right.
So if it was a gasoline, it'd be all over her freaking face.
Right. Or if it was an acid attack too, then it would probably be all over her face and it would be permanently disfigured. Okay, here we go. What's up, Cyrax?
So, Marty, you call yourself the greatest rapper alive, right?
Yeah, it's pretty good. Let me play my song for you.
No. I want you, if you're so good, let's see you come up with something right now, on the spot, off the top of your dome.
I've already beaten rap battles, dude.
Go ahead.
See, I want to see you react
to my
phone.
That's the thing, bro. You can't even come up with anything off the top of your fucking dome.
That's what I want to do.
You can't even come up with anything on the fucking spot.
Here you go, Sarek. Let me see what this.
Why, check this out. Marty, you're a little motherfucker bitch.
I just want to see your reaction while I play my song, because you haven't listened to it yet, I don't think.
Cyrax, we can be together forever. We can make it through the weather. I don't care if it's a storm. I don't care if we are the norm. You can do magical things. You have to believe in me, Cyrax. Together we can reach the climax in our careers. YouTube is a job. Definitely is everything I do for my income. That's where I derive my funds. That's a real thing, oh yeah. Cyrax, I believe in you. Wanna be in you. You are my man. I love that you were influenced by Japan. Wanna kiss you on the head. I can hear you. Kiss you inside of the bed. Oh, my friend. Don't mind that I wanna put it in your rear end sirens. Put my fingers inside of your anus. Together, you will be famous. I want to hold you, put on your hips. Cyrax, I want to kiss you on the quality.
Slit your throat right in front of your mouth and your pops. Maybe then I'll kill them along with you.
Send the beat. Send the beat, dude. Send the beat. My car does the talking.
From me to you, this is the personal one that I've been working on for the last few days. It's something I've had in mind that I wanted to show you. All right, so sit, because I saw your little song towards me, and it was cute. It was cute. Not gonna lie, I'll give you an A for effort. I'll give you an A for effort on that. But here's my song to you for that song. So.
Jump, who is this little whack ass motherfucking sign? Kind of motherfucker always wanted to run his motherfucking mouth. Man, this dude so motherfucking upset to me. Somebody send this dude back to the mental hospital. Honestly, I'm glad that Jimmy thinks now she ain't gotta worry about your fat ass doing what you motherfucking doing, thinking that you stopped me, nigga. You are never ever gonna be keeping up me. I am the next Eminem, I am the next M9. I don't need a motherfucking watch, cause I always make time like a motherfucking boss. Oh God, look at the time, I don't need a fucking watch. Run, I'm got you on my motherfucking time. You ain't a motherfucking boss, goddamn, like me. You are never ever doing anything, so don't think for a second that I am ever gonna step into your butt. All you're doing is getting up in the motherfucking walls on your entering the motherfucking wall that you about to lose. You ain't nothing but a pathetic ass bitch ass wannabe dude. So why the fuck you running up into my space? We all know your history, mate. All you're doing is drinking that motherfucking liquor, get a motherfucking stone off those eddies every motherfucking day. God damn, why you getting so motherfucking stoned off those fucking addies? Why don't you go to AAA, getting a little bit of motherfucking help? God damn, don't make me have to motherfucking pull my pistol up of the motherfucking shelf. But yeah, now leave that shit alone. Pull my motherfucking AR-15 from the floor. Put that shit to your dome. Pull the trigger back, say goodbye, motherfucker, cause this is the end of you. Don't touch me or you will see just how evil I can be with you.
So Marty, let me tell you right now, motherfucker, when it comes to me being a supposed pedo, well, let's be fucking real here. You have no real fucking proof. If I really was a pedo, let me ask you this. If I really was a pedo, then why the fuck was I not arrested the night the cops showed up, you dumb fuck? Obviously, I'm not a pedo. I don't have a fucking history of it. I was never fucking arrested for being a pedo. Matter of fact, the cop that showed up here even said that I wasn't, bro. You have no tangible fucking proof. If I really was a fucking pedophile, I would have been arrested that fucking night, you fucking retard.
Sarah, here's how things work, dude. Like, do you know who Jerry Sandusky was? I think he's at Penn State, which is a neighboring state. Do you know who Jerry Sandusky was?
Bro, you want a real pedo? Well, reports.
So what about Tony? Do you think Tony's a real pedophile, Sarah?
Oh, look, the bitch boy's me.
Do you think that Tony's a real pedophile, Sarah?
Hold on. Let me say
Simple question. Is Tony a real pedophile?
Let me say something, bro. Shut the fuck up.
No, it's a simple question. If you can't handle it, it's a yes or no answer. Do you think that Tony's a real pedophile?
Let me explain my fucking point about...
No, it's a simple question. You can explain your point after you answer the question. Rainbow? That's a fact, dude.
I'll be honest, Marty. I don't see what Saren sees in your ass, bro. Because all I see is a worthless...
Well, me neither.
So this is pretty much the same old we usually get out of a music biz, Marty and Cyrax meetup. I think you guys get the gist. We'll skim through to the end here.
Me neither, dude. Me neither, honestly, but...
I deserve to even be on any platform, but then neither do you. So, I mean, I guess it fits. I mean, bro, you don't think I don't see what you do, dog? You're a fucking bitch-made pussy. I already know about your whole goddamn past. I know about your record, motherfucker.
Yeah, no, I'm aware of
the thing, Marty. You're just mad at the fact that I'm making you look like a fucking idiot in front of thousands of people, dude.
Sorry, X. How are you making me look stupid in front of thousands of people? I'll give you the opportunity to respond. I'm curious.
Fuck with people because I'm a retard. My name's Marty.
Hey, Cyrax, do you know what 7x4 is?
Sorry, I can't do that in Google Chrome.
Oh, sorry, my fucking
Siri. For real, bro, you're a fucking idiot.
Cyrax, you know what 7x4 is? Something that most 8-year-olds can come up with. Yet you can't. Look, yeah, there you go. Okay, so can't do it, can you?
You are such a fucking...
No, so you want to answer that. Can you do what 7x4 is? Can you do 7x4? Can you do that one? Can you do that one, Cyrax? I'm just trying to understand, like, where you're at intellectually.
For real, Marty, you're fucking dumb.
Cyrax, I hate... Because, listen, as long as I leave you backstage, you're going to keep routing or ranting and spouting off of the mouth. And there he goes. And listen, that's a pretty good point to end it. That's a great point to end it. When you're asked what 7x4 is and you don't know the answer, and let's double down here. When you're asked what 7x4 is and you still don't know the answer, I'll tell you this. It was pretty interesting seeing Cyrax respond to my love song. It was pretty nice.
We'll be right back after these messages.
I should have been entitled to make this channel where I could have made money. But no, that four eyes, ugly, disgusting little prick by the name of Shiva had to get me demonetized. So now I'm going to purposely live on the government's dime. I'm going to purposely collect food stamps. I'm going to purposely live on your tax dollars. Do you know, Dragonite, one time restreamed one of my broadcasts and made almost $1,200 in super chats? Yeah, Dragonite, stealing my content, one broadcast, over $1,200 in revenue that could have been mine, should have been mine.
All right, trolls exposed and not paying attention to the chat. No offense to anybody. I don't want to be sidetracked. Trolls exposed for who they really are. I'm going to expose trolls using this parlor trick I learned. The smoke and mirrors, black powder magic, bullshit nonsense that we call deductive reasoning. And I'm not talking about all the troll groups. I understand that supposedly there's groups of trolls out there who are actually doing good things. And I guess that should be applauded, although it's still not fucking legal. However, I'm speaking of the trolls in the circle I run that I'm aware of. You know, the Canadian, the other guy, you know, the British folk. Michiganite. See, it's not hard. Well, apparently it must be hard. The people can't see fucking reality for what the hell it is. See, these people run around claiming that what they're doing is to protect the kids. See, I even have to say it that way so one of the assholes doesn't clip that and make it into something that it's not. Right, but that's what they say. We're trying to protect the kids from bad people on the internet. Really? Let's look at that for a second, because I'm going to turn that into Swiss fucking cheese. They claim they're doing that to protect someone from seeing something or hearing something they shouldn't say. The same fucking people who will hijack somebody's live stream and play pornographic fucking material sit there and say They're trying to protect the keys. Motherfucker, please. Trying to protect somebody from bad people. You're the fucking bad people. I'm going to make that apparent and abundantly clear here in the next 5 minutes or so. So the same fuck people who don't want somebody else on the internet, you know, the self-appointed deputies of the vigilante loser gang, right? Same fuck people who claim they're doing good shit will show pornographic material on a fucking website that they know certain other people might be hanging around and shouldn't see. Interesting. The same fucking people who will sit there and tell somebody they're the lowest form of life because they lied about cancer.
No. Talk about equivocating. Folks, so this is his newest angle, spinning it while he's trying to rationalize. I always find it interesting that this guy always tries to cast Emo and Rick as just mentally handicapped people that, that everyone's picking on. And no doubt they have their issues, but the question is, why are you hanging out with them every fucking night, dude? Why are you hanging out with these people? So if you haven't caught it, this is his newest spin. So we can't criticize Rick for admitting to watching CP with his husband, who is now in jail for activities going on with children that were friends of Rick that Rick introduced his husband to. You can't criticize Rick for that. Because you're making fun of a guy who once claimed he had cancer. You guys remember when he shaved his head and pretended to have cancer? It has nothing to do with the fucking cancer, dude. He is trying to say the people that porn bomb Rick are as bad or worse because there may be a chance that someone in the audience is watching and is a minor and you've subjected them to pornography. Dude, you're defending a dude who admitted to, like, performing oral sex on his husband while he watched videos of children. Who actually went to jail for doing shit with children. I'm just... it's not the same. And it's not because Rick pretended to have cancer.
Okay. That person didn't make that lie up. The trolls made that lie up. And then that person, just after 3 days of being battered by it, decided to play along. Well, that person's a bad person for lying about having cancer. Yet the same fucking people who think it's bad to lie about cancer don't seem to have a fucking problem making up a fake fucking obituary about somebody. The same fucking cunts that'll sit there and say, oh, it's wrong to wish death upon people. Because, of course, only somebody with a fifth grade mentality would believe that wishing for something actually fucking does something. Now, the same assholes that say it's wrong to wish death upon people will create a fucking obituary saying somebody's dead when they're not really dead and laugh about it. I'm pretty sure those people are behind it. If not, I'm pretty sure they're laughing about it. The same fucking people that want to go after another person and call them a fucking racist and stuff sit right there on Nelly's live stream. In less than 60 seconds, and made a racial slur about Mexicans, laughed at somebody being killed by a cop, laughed about a woman being held at gunpoint, a woman who was pregnant, by the way, and then made an abortion joke about the woman being held at gunpoint who was pregnant. Really? Really? These are the people that say they're trying to protect certain people from certain other people on the internet, right? You guys are the motherfucking problem, and your bullshit lie that you're doing it for the good of fucking humanity is goddamn horse shit. See, what really it is, and I'm not a doctor, but what I think it is, see, these people have this ailment called sadism. They're sadists. They're all sadists. They take pleasure and fucking with other people. They're sadists. Now, I know that usually comes with an aspect of a sexual aspect to it. I fully believe in my mind that these motherfuckers actually get off on fucking with other people just to do it, right? Just to do it. Not because there's a reason behind it. No, just because they think it's funny. Well, I guess that would be a reason behind it. Not a good reason behind it. We think it's funny.
So, just to put it in perspective again, this is a man who defends the grifter and the pedo prince that he chooses to hang out with behind a wall of, oh, they're helpless handicapped men. He gets the name. You'll see us refer to him as the Shrimpin' Trucker if you're new to all this. This is a guy who hangs out, and we know the history of at least one of them, right? Who claimed? So tell me if this is appropriate. You know Rick's past. You claim that he's, you know, an innocent victim that has all these mental problems, which he does have issues. Let's be honest. Do you think it's appropriate, knowing his past, hanging out with this man while defending him, to talk about acts like shrimping, which apparently, I don't know how you'd know this, but according to this guy, is after one man has set anal sex with another man, he sucks out the leftovers. And this is, in a sense, with a straw or something, or I can't remember. Why would he be talking about that with these people? With these mentally handicapped people, where at least one of them has been involved with some very serious illegal sexual activities. Another thing about Rick is supposedly he's HIV positive and he's been caught on gay dating sites getting hookups with guys. So Rick knows the difference between right and wrong. Just want to put that out there.
Ha ha ha. Funny shit, right? And you know what? Most people ignore that shit, but you can only push somebody so far until they goddamn snap. You see, that's what happens. And sadly, the person who snaps ends up being the quote-unquote bad guy. See, because as much as fucktard wants to fuck with me and shit, he's been warned multiple fucking times. Warned. Plenty of fucking times. Now, see, and I'm not the guy, if his head ends up going down a bowling alley lane, that guy was a psychopath, a sociopath. He was just an angry person on the internet. He hates people, and he's fucking bam, 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 bam. I don't know. You think I want to throw his head down a fucking bowling alley lane? No. He wants me to throw his fucking head down a bowling alley lane. He begs me to do it, pretty much. Why? Because that's the dude. Just leave me alone. Go the fuck away. See, I'm the guy. I'm not the guy that takes the law into my own hands. That's you fucking trolls. You're the ones that take the law into your own hands. I'm the guy that emailed the fucking FBI 2.5 years ago with no response, that called the FBI 2 years ago and got hung up on, that spoken to the state police for 45 minutes. They said they were going to do something. What do you want to do, sir? I want an investigation started. Okay, I'll have the district attorney's office call you Monday morning, and you can get that procedure started. District attorney's office never fucking called me at all. Called the state police back a second time about threats and bullshit. And the fucking goddamn trooper laughed at me under his breath, right? They don't give a fuck. But though, here's me, the guy doing shit the legal way. You know, trying to do shit the fucking legal way. I printed out 100 goddamn screenshots. I spent 2 hours sitting here in this fucking truck. Printed out 100 goddamn screenshots in color. And then I sat there and I made notes on every single fucking page. This guy right here admitting to be the leader of a group of people who are doing this down here, which is a felony under 18 USC, blah, blah, blah. This person who also goes by these names, wrote them down, sat there for 2 hours explaining everything on the paper. And then I did a 25-minute video and I put it in an overnight fucking envelope and I sent it to Dr. Phil thinking, hey, here's a guy who claims to give a shit about shit. No. Instead, he cares about doing fucking TV shows about women who want to get butt implants and let their armpit hair grow out and blah, blah, blah. Contacted Steve Wilkos about it to no fucking avail. Steve Wilkos doesn't give a fucking shit either. Here's a goddamn piece of shit. Former fucking pig acts like he gives a shit about something. But he does a whole show revolving around lie detector test results, which he full and well knows are inadmissible in any fucking court in this country. Buddy does it anyway because it pays him fucking money. Right? So I'm the guy doing all the legal fucking shit, trying to use the legal fucking process to get you guys, the people who take the law into your own hands and commit felonies on a daily fucking basis. That's me. But when somebody's head end up going down a fucking bowling alley lane, he's a bad person. He just says same fucking people. You want to sit around and fuck with people who say things they don't like. Because we're protecting people on the internet. The same people who think they're better than other fucking people aren't. They're fucking criminals. They haven't been charged. There's no accountability. They do their bullshit with impunity somehow. Nobody fucking cares.
I just want to openly say, yes, I think I'm better than someone who enables chomos. Definitely. Yeah.
Same fucking people are the fucking problem. They're the fucking problem with the goddamn internet. Not Rick. And I'm going to go right on ahead and fucking say it right now, and you can clip it. You can fucking shove it right up your fucking ass. None of you motherfuckers are better than Rick any day of the goddamn week. None of you. You're sadist pieces of shit who want to take the law into your own hands, even though the law has actually been involved here. See? Oh, you want to say Rick's normal. He understands the difference between right and wrong. Rick's normal. Really? Let's look at that for a fucking second. I can tell Rick 25 times before he goes live that that's not going to be Jay in the chat. 10 minutes into the chat, fake Jay shows up. What does Rick do? Is that really you? I'm going to mod you. Really? That's normal behavior. Pixie. And I don't know the ins and outs of it, but somehow lured Rick into a conversation that she then recorded. And then gave that recording to multiple fucking people. Multiple fucking people called the fucking cops on Rick with that fucking recording. By the way, the cops did nothing about it. There's nothing they're going to do. There's nothing they can do. Whatever the fuck the case is. Law enforcement isn't doing anything.
I'm sorry, Wilson donated $5 through Super Chat. This episode of Weirdo Wonderland is brought to you by Abortions Aris. At least we throw chomos down the highest flight of stairs.
Nice. Thank you, Wilson.
Right. Pixie, same person. What does Rick do? Pixie comes in his chat. Rick's nice to her. Hey, Pixie, how you doing? Lets her up on the fucking panel. Eric, who sat there on his panel 3 weeks ago and said, you know, he was taking shit from the chat. Oh, you support this, you support that. Sat right there and said he has spent the last 2.5 fucking years in contact with the Bristol PD, trying to get Rick fucking arrested. Right? So here's two people. There's actually more. I'm not going to name the rest of them that have called the cops on Rick. And what does Rick do? Well, he lets those people on his panel. And he hangs out with them like nothing ever happened. You're fucking going to tell me that you're going to go hang out with people who have been trying to get you arrested for 3 years, and that would be considered what you dumb motherfuckers call normal behavior? How about this one? Because I'm either going to prove that you're fucking stupid, or once again, that your agenda is bullshit. You go in there under the fake Jay accounts, put in the dot. Rick says, is that really you, Jay? Of course you do that because you know it's like a stupid drinking game to you idiots. Every time Rick says Jay's name, we're going to DDoS Jay. Fucking goddamn idiots. Losers. Fucking absolute goddamn losers. So then you type Messenger. And what does Rick say? I tried to add you on Messenger. You haven't responded. And then you type Facebook. Well, I've tried to add you on Facebook, but you haven't added me. Discord. Well, Nemesis gave you the link to Discord, and he said he didn't want anything to goddamn do with it. So that right there proves that Jay's not in the fucking picture anymore. Jay doesn't want anything to do with Rick. You know, and I tell Rick this, sad but true, bud, that Jay doesn't want anything to do with it. He doesn't want to be on your Discord. And you fucking idiots, see, if you really thought Jay was in the picture and that's why you're doing some of the shit you're doing, that should fucking prove that he's not. through, you know, that parlor trick bullshit of deductive fucking goddamn reasoning. Well, the bigger one would have been, if Jay had anything to do with Rick's streams, he would have never porn bombed his channel off YouTube because Jay would have just ended it. Jesus Christ. It's like playing cards with my cousins. Bunch of nerve-wracking sons of bitches. Little fucking tombstone for you. Any goddamn way. I could go on for a fucking hour.
Grayman donated $5 Canadian through Super Chat. And when waiting for your appointment at Abortions R Us, come to Mystery Meat Soup Emporium. The meat may be a mystery, but the soup is fantastic.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, folks, thank you very much. Yeah, well, the question is here, Shrimpin' Trucker, is why are you playing cards? I mean, you just made that analogy of playing cards with your cousins. Like, that's the question. Why are you even at the table? Like, what's your... Anyways.
Or with all the dumb fucking bullshit. See, that just blows holes in your bullshit goody two shoes fucking agenda.
You said, what should I do?
You only have one agenda. You're fucking sadist. And you enjoy fucking with people.
I'm sorry, Wilson has just donated $2 through Super Chat.
Here it is.
It's not a mystery. The meat is babies.
Okay, folks, I apologize. All right, let's keep. Thank you, Wilson, for
the
input.
But I'm going to say it one more time. So you're only going to push somebody so fucking far until they fucking snap. All right. And then once again, the person who snaps is going to look like the bad guy. The same person who's been trying to use the legal fucking process for 2.5 goddamn years to stop you fucking goddamn hypocrite motherfuckers from committing felonies is going to end up being the bad guy in the end. Let that sink in. That's good fucking shit right there. That is falls right under the very definition of good fucking shit. It's like YouTube and their bullshit. So gluten allegedly, I think it was gluten, porn bombs Rick, which is against terms of service. You guys want to sit there and say, well, Rick's in violation of terms of service. No. Rick got blamed for the terms of service violations that you assholes did. You assholes violated terms of fucking service, and then you want to blame somebody else for the goddamn shit. YouTube wants to blame somebody else for the goddamn shit. Once again, right back into the fucking pocket of good fucking shit. But make no fucking mistake about it. You're not good people. I don't care if you pat each other on the back all goddamn day, you know, high five, air pat, air high five each other. You're not good fucking people. And I'm even going to say it one level farther. Rick is a better person than any fucking one of you people any day of the goddamn week. Why? Because he's not committing crimes. Sure, he says some fucked up shit and has in the past. And you know what? Can't go back and take it back.
Right, you can't go back and take it back. And the things that he was admitting to, technically, are fucking crimes. So he's the criminal. This is how fucking stupid you are. Anyways, he's almost done here, folks.
Go back and take it back. He's not the one that keeps bringing it up. He's trying to forget it, let it go. No. You assholes are the ones that keep bringing it up. And the Martin shit, why do you do that? Well, you bring up Martin in the chat. Why? Because another stupid fucking drinking game with you fucking morons. Every time Rick says something nice about Martin, the phone calls start coming in, the takeaways, the taxis, the bullshit, the fucking nonsense. Right? You guys are the good guys. Motherfucker, please. You're all fucking scumbags. Y'all deserve to die. I'm calling the Wish Fairy tonight and wishing for death upon you people. Because that'll work. Because you're idiots that believe wishing and hoping for things actually changes something. Or making a joke about cancer makes it worse. But it's okay to make jokes about people being dead when they're not really fucking dead. My fucking God. See, I'd like to just think you're really that stupid. It's like, okay, they don't really know any better because they're obviously fucking degenerates. But no, you know better, which means you do it intentionally. Which, back to the original point of this shit, makes your bullshit fucking agenda that you're doing it to protect somebody just that. Bullshit. Bull fucking shit. See all you fuckers in fake hell, and by God, would you drink more Ovaltine, because I keep buying stock in that shit, and I'm trying to make some money off.
Folks, since we had to endure the Shrimpin' Trucker, I thought I'd play a recent emo rage out. Now, this isn't brand new. Emo's been pretty quiet, too. But this is one of his last major freakouts. We featured it maybe a month ago. I can't remember exactly when this happened. But this is when he rages at Panda. So I thought, what the heck, we just check out a little. Since we had to endure the other guy, we'll check out some emo rage and then move on to the features of the evening. Folks, please thumbs up the video. We got more to come right now.
Oh, what about committing identity theft, asshole?
Yeah, I want to let everybody know that there's a channel going around posting me and Rick's content. And when I copyright strike it yesterday, guess what it came back as? It came back as the owner of being Rick Berry. But that ain't Rick Berry's channel. That's that's the faggot Evil Panda's channel, who's committing felonies and fraud on a YouTube document. And you want to take me on, Evil Panda? I'll take you on, you cocksucker! You want to commit fraud? You want to commit felonies? You fucking low-life fucking faggot! So how am I supposed to file the next step in the copyright claim when this asshole ain't using his real name? He's committing fraud on YouTube! You want to take me on, Evil Panda? Come on! Bring it, like, you cocksucking faggot! Come on, you low-life fucking faggot!
I'm all done.
JL has just donated $1.99 through Super Chat. Wrench, please. No chomo.
Oh, thank you for your $1.99 donation, sir.
Yeah, you're impersonating Rick. That's identity theft. That's against the law, asshole. That's illegal, faggot. Ben Chode, low-life fucking faggot! You want to take me on, Evil Panda? Come on, let's go, motherfucker! You just lied on a legal fucking document, you fucking panda, Evil Panda fucking faggot! Just because I borrow some money from a little old lady and I'm having a hard time paying it back, that doesn't make me a scumbag. Just because you guys are using the wrong birthday doesn't make me a fucking a criminal. But guess what, Evil Panda? You're a fucking faggot and a fucking criminal for lying on 3 Google counterclaims. You low-life fucking faggot. And if I knew where you were, Panda, I would fucking kill you tonight. If I knew where you were, Panda, I would fucking kill you. because that faggot, Evil Panda, was in me and always gloating about it. So that Evil Panda can kiss my fucking cock and suck it. Because he's a liar. He's a faggot and a fucking liar. You want to fucking take me on, asshole? Take me on, cocksucker! Because I never lied on the YouTube document. I've always told the truth. Can you tell the truth, Evil Panda? Can you tell the truth, you fucking low-life fucking faggot? Huh? Can you tell the truth, you low-life fucking faggot? And flag this fucking stream. I don't give a shit. The fucking guy lied on the fucking legal document. And if I knew where the fuck he was, I'd kill him tonight. I'd fucking kill him. If I could get through this, if I could put my hand on the screen right now and through the screen and come out the other side, I would fucking kill Evil Panda. He's a low-life fucking faggot and a liar. And a fucking liar! You know what, Rudy? I'm tired of your bullshit. Guess what? I'm gonna kick your ass out. You wanna fucking start your shit tonight? I'm in a real good fucking mood. I'm in a real good fucking mood. You wanna fucking, when you keep putting your fucking shit in your fucking place with fucking, where your fucking comments and your fucking shit is unwanted? Get the fuck out of my server. Goodbye. Bye, faggot! Bye, faggot! Get the fuck out of here, you two-timing piece of shit. You two-time fucking faggot piece of shit. So like I said, Panda lied on 3 Google documents under the perjury of law, because he's not Rick Berry. Do I have to bring the fucking evidence up on the screen of where this fucking faggot lied on a fucking legal document? Yeah, let's bring the fucking document up on the screen, shall we? Yeah, let's share the fucking screen, because I'm in a fucking roll tonight. Let's share the fucking screen where this fucking guy lied on a fucking Google document. Come on, let's go. Let's show what a fucking asshole liar he is. Come on. Come on, Panda. Let's show how much of a fucking liar you are. Okay? Let's show how much of a fucking liar you are, Evil Panda. Yeah, look at this, people. Look at this fucking faggot. Look at what he wrote. Look at what this faggot wrote. He wrote out this long paragraph
And then look what he used as the doc information. Look what he used as the docs. He used Rick Berry's fucking information. And he's not fucking Rick Berry. Evil Panda is not fucking Rick Berry. He's a fraud. He forged a fake legal document. This is forgery.
And this is Emo doxing yet another friend of his because he's so fucking stupid. So, just saying.
They say that I do things wrong on YouTube. I don't break the law, asshole. I do things legit. I don't lie on a government fucking form, you fucking faggot.
Farmer in the Cell donated $19.99 through Super Chat. Mike Fund.
Well, thank you very much. I do appreciate that, folks. Thank you.
So then it says the next step is they're going to file in the court injunction in federal court. Well, how can I file a court injunction in federal court when this ain't Rick Berry? This is a fraud! This is a fake! Yeah, and it's that piece of shit, Evil Panda. I would love to fucking kill Evil Panda. You deserve death, Evil Panda. You deserve to fucking die. Because you fuck with me tonight, and I'm pissed. That's forgery right there on the screen. Forgery in black and white. Lies on the screen in black and white. You're a fraud, evil monkey. I mean, evil panda. You're a fucking fraud. And if I knew where the fuck you were, you would be fucking dead. Do you understand me, Evil Panda? If I knew where the fuck you are, you would be fucking dead. Now kiss my ass. Thank you and good night.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Do you like eating chicken?
Do you like eating butthole?
Then bring your happy ass to Clancy's Fried Chicken Butthole Emporium Unlimited.
100% chicken butthole.
That's right, folks. We got big chicken buttholes, little chicken buttholes, moist chicken buttholes. And coming soon to the chicken butthole family,
Beep Jack.
We got buttholes so good you'll be licking that shit right off your damn fingers. Woo! Clancy's Fried Chicken Butthole Emporium Unlimited. Come get your butthole. Yee-haw!
Hi, guys. Zop. I got some munchy food. I am hungry. I haven't eaten anything all day, and I wanted some nice, healthy food to eat. Semi-healthy. Anyway, what do I have to eat? So, my lovelies, my wonderful, wonderful people. How am I sounding, by the way?
I don't know.
That's the biggest thing. Is sound check. Sound check, 1, 2, 3, because...
Mic check.
The mic check all the way. Oh. Mic check, huh?
Wonderful, wonderful. Wow.
Oh, I sound really good.
Really good. That's the rock band mic, folks.
All right. Well, I guess I'm good.
Yeah, you are.
So, okay, what do I have? I went to this Native American place, mm-hmm. and they have nice organic food.
Yeah. vegan.
And it's vegan-ish. Well, it's not vegan-ish.
No, really, I guess.
Please, honey. They can't hear you. Anyway. Anyway, I got really good food today. So I got some jalapeno bites, and they have like what it said. I saw it and I was like, oh my God, they're so good. Like, as you can see, it's jalapeno that's been roasted, and it has cream cheese. It has Tillamook cheddar cheese, cilantro, bacon, and pico de gallo. And then I have a wrap here, which is lettuce, tomatoes, red onion, chicken, and I think some cheddar cheese. I also have some roasted potatoes and some refried beans. And this is like a little accoutrement this came with, which is onions, tomatoes, some pepperoncinis, and then avocado, which is delightful. And then we have the sauces. Let me see if I can put this back so you guys can see the sauces, because that's probably one of the most happiest. We have a, what is this? A salsa, I think, like a roasted tomato salsa. And then we have a honey mustard. I'm thinking that's going to be delicious. We have a barbecue sauce, even more better. We have a sour cream crema, which is amazing. Oh my God, that tastes amazing. And this is their ranch. Now, if you ever went to a Native Americans like food restaurant, you will know that Native Americans probably make the best ranch you will ever have in your entire existence. I'm not kidding. I don't know what they do with it. They just make it just perfect in every way, shape, and form. Oh my God, look at that. That's beautiful, folks. Oh! It's okay.
Yes.
Oh my God. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Like I said, best ranch you would ever sneak and have. So delicious. I'm so excited over this. I don't know where to start. Baby, where do you think I should start?
Word is, Shani said that the best Native ranch she ever had came out of the end of a Native Pringle can. I don't want to skip up ahead. This is a classic, folks. This is the classic. I don't really care about her eating this stuff. Of course, she does. Finally, he sits down. I just love this look, the Hugh Hefner, and he just absolutely slops the whole front of his face with Shani's Native ranch, folks.
Nick, you got to find a Native place. When you come out here, maybe we get this one.
Maybe.
Wherever you want to eat, we'll take you. We'll take you on a fucking eating tour around where we are.
Yep. Be really cool, actually.
Absolutely. Where's my drink? I have nothing to drink.
Oh, no.
I could have sworn I had a freaking Diet Coke.
You don't have anything to drink, baby?
Yeah, I do.
Oh.
It's somewhere.
You sure?
Uh-oh, maybe not.
Oh, my Lord Jesus.
I'm out of drinking booze.
Well, I'm just going to have to order you something.
No, it's all right. Maybe I can. There they are. They're open, but I got them.
Oh.
Here we go.
Oh.
I'm good.
Okay.
For now.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Oh,
my God. I want to dig into these veggies here.
I wish I had more veggies, to tell you the truth.
Well, you could. Here. You gave me freaking two containers. Here.
Oh, love, I love you.
Yeah, no, never mind. Here. Yeah, there's another one. There you go.
Yes. I only want specific veggies.
It's salsa, folks. This is salsa, right? I can't wait to try their salsa. Ooh.
I haven't tried it, actually.
You haven't either?
No.
Oh,
You said, what should I do?
Oh, yummy.
No, this is salsa. That's a.
I'm sorry, Wilson has just donated $2 through Super Chat. Pie, pika, pika ilmi.
Indeed, indeed, Wilson. All right, moving right along here. Sorry, I'm having issues with the mouse.
Delicious. Like a fired roasted tomato salsa.
What?
It's so good. Hi, Lulz Junkie. How are you?
You know what it almost has the flavor of, Shani?
What?
An Indian stew. Is there like cardamom in this? In your salsa?
Possibly.
Oh, yeah. There's an Indian flavor in there. It's not too spicy, Nick. It's really good, Nick. Yeah, you got to find a native restaurant, dude.
Just got in from physio and dealing with some work stuff over the phone. Read above Rev's head.
Happy Halloween.
He looks very different again. You look different.
Yeah, I know.
Why do you look different?
It's the bleached hair.
Oh!
You haven't seen me with the bleached hair yet. I do look totally different.
That might be it.
Oh, God.
I can't...
Can I try some of your dipping sauces?
Yeah.
Can I?
Which ones?
Okay. What is the one second to the right?
This one?
No.
That one.
That one.
That is their barbecue.
Can I try that?
Yes.
Because I'm pretty sure this is incredible. Here we go. Barbecue. Native barbecue.
Yep.
Uh-huh. It's like A1 and Heinz 57 combined.
Yeah!
Unbelievable.
It does taste like that, doesn't it?
It's A1 and Heinz 57.
We're eating native food.
Very raw. Almost.
From a Native American restaurant.
Yeah.
It's all raw. Well, not all. It's not raw, but it's all organic food. And I have some jalapeno poppers. I have a chicken wrap. I have some roasted potatoes.
I want to try one of them.
The roasted potato?
Mm-hmm.
You want me to dip it in anything? I got the sour cream right there.
Yeah, crema. Sour cream.
There you go.
Oh, my God. Look at this.
I'll put it in the crema for you.
Thank you. And here's back your barbecue. That's exactly what I want in my mouth every day.
Oh, I can't even touch it. Folks, you know how the sheer volume of body fluids, that mattress that they're eating this meal on, has absorbed over the time, the brief time that they were in this apartment? Just the back sweat alone. Remember when they were stir-frying on the... Oh, God.
Aside from
you
want to
try the jalapeno
body.
Popper? Want to try the jalapeno popper?
Oh, there was bacon in those potatoes.
Yeah.
In there. Okay, yeah, I'll take it.
See, it's so good.
This is disgusting to me. The meat tastes rotten.
Yeah, I know. That's the biggest thing. We just need to go full freaking vegan.
Oh, my freaking God.
Mm-hmm.
What?
That's so good, isn't it?
It's not spicy at all either. Oh, my God, Nick. Nick, you've never had... Oh, my God. Yeah, we have to take him here, right? When we told Lab, we're going here. This is one of the stops. Definitely.
Oh, yeah.
I never tasted food like this in my life.
Me, I can't eat that much. That's the biggest problem. It's like, I cannot eat.
You're like, you're not a mukbanger because you can't eat enough.
You want to try this?
So they keep calling this native, But as far as I can tell, none of the, and someone correct me if I'm wrong, none of the cuisine is actually technically like Native American food that I'm aware of. I mean, do they mean it's just a restaurant run by Native Americans? So by default, everything they eat is, oh my God, it's Native American. I think I've solved this riddle before, but I can't remember.
Yeah, it's me. It doesn't matter now.
Yep.
I broke it for the
day. It's delicious.
Oh my God, do I get this half? I get
here. You can have the ranch too with it.
Oh, we love ranch. We love cheese and ranch.
You know, I'm wearing the InfoWars shirt because it was a big shirt. It was in my closet.
Exactly.
And I needed something to wear to bed.
It's not exactly. It's not anything. She don't support Alex at all.
No, I don't support Alex in any way, shape, or form.
Shape or form. InfoWars is still, it's a mission to get.
But it's an iconic shirt.
It is, Barry, because it looks like G.I. Joe.
I know. Mm. So good.
This is sinful.
I know it is. Mm. Mm.
Mm. Folks. Uh-uh. No, 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 no. This place is 10 stars, dude. Just face, I don't care. This is fucking delicious.
Mm. Yeah, Tex-Mex.
It really is. Mm.
This is almost tzatziki-like in a little bit ways, too.
It's tangy.
It really is.
Oh my God, Shandy, it's tangy. Look at this fool. Look at this fucking fool back here.
Oh my God.
Oh, you racist bastard. I love you. Look at this shit.
I literally bathed it in ranch. Oh my God. Folks, this is not acceptable behavior for an individual like myself.
No.
Oh my God.
No.
I got carried away with the ranch. Oh my God. See, I was talking about Pete's and the way he cut his meat to my wife, and now I'm making an idiot of myself on the internet like this. God. This is not becoming of an individual.
No, but it's perfect TV.
I guess it is, right? Mm. They're like Rev has fucking jizz all over his face.
Oh.
See?
It's okay.
It's all right. Mm. Jesus does not hate homosexuals, by the way.
Nope.
He don't.
Nope.
At all.
Nope.
Oh, yeah. He'd stand up for them because they're so afflicted, actually. Yep. That's the truth.
Here. I'm going to dip it in the crema and then the barbecue sauce.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Try that.
What is this? A potato?
With the crema and the barbecue sauce.
All right. Male individuals in the room need to go get native food.
Mm-hmm. Let me try this honey mustard.
I feel like a savage eating this shit.
Mm. Ooh.
This is so good.
That's a honey mustard.
Their chicken Ooh. Is fucking...
That's crazy.
It tastes like CBD honey.
Oh, what?
It does.
It probably is, man.
Knowing the natives, yeah, I know. It tastes like CBD honey.
They love their weed.
They do love their weed.
Love their weed. Oh, look at how thick they're...
It's thick honey mustard.
Oh, my God.
I'll save that for you.
Oh, my God, Shani.
You can keep that in your little...
No, I can't even deal with this food. We're like Pete's and Chantal, except...
We are like Pete's and Chantal.
Except we actually do fucking... kiss.
Oh my god, yeah.
We actually fucking kiss, and I think
no, not Mexican food, Hannah. This is Native American food.
It's Native food, which is
the best food.
It's better than Mexican.
It's better
than. And I'm not hating on Mexican cuisine because that's one of my favorites. My number one favorite cuisine of all time is Thai food. Okay, that's my favorite.
That's your favorite?
Yeah. Second would be Greek. Followed closely by Mexican. That's my top three. Like they say down there, how about that Joe Biden guy, yeah?
My favorite food.
Oh my God.
My favorite food. Salad.
Mm-hmm.
Sushi.
Uh-huh.
And probably Italian.
And Italian.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I forgot about Italian. I chose mine. Thai is my number one. It will always will be. But Indian is in mine too.
Mm.
Indian has to be at the top. It's tied with Thai.
I say Indian is one of the best food, actually in the top, number one.
For you?
For native food, yeah. Indian. Because native food.
Oh, native for you, yeah.
Native food.
It's your favorite.
Because it's always organic, it's always clean tasting, and it doesn't like make your stomach feel
like it's gonna explode.
Yeah, it doesn't feel bad at all. These peppers are bomb.
Are they?
The jalapeno pop.
Oh, they are fucking.
You want another one?
No, I don't.
Okay.
But I am gonna.
They are bomb. The potatoes are bomb too.
Did you guys know that jalapeno poppers are indigenous to the northern states? First Nations. Did you know that?
They're like these little new potatoes. Oh. They're so good.
Hey, Shani, we got a pepper and zini situation. Oh, my God. I love pepper and zini. Pepper and chino. Pickled red onion. Is it pickled?
I'm not sure.
It's so fresh.
I agree with the white flour and pasta. I can't consume that much anymore. You see this? This is pita bread. I haven't touched it.
I had like two pieces, yeah. Two or three.
I don't know. I'm just like, seriously.
Oh my God, Shani, taste those onions.
I have. Best food for me, in my opinion, for me to eat
raw.
Is like, probably like raw,
almost
vegan, raw vegan food, but with like a splash of cheese.
Yeah, so a little cheese.
A little cheese, but mostly vegan.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And you get the lacto.
Just a splash.
And you also get the pescatarian with the fish, you know?
But every once in a while, I need like chicken or some kind of meat because I get very anemic.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, okay, I'm starting to bruise. I guess I'm going to have to eat some meat now.
That's correct. You do get
it. I hate that.
It sucks, but you got to do it. Salmon. Yeah, like a consistent diet of salmon.
Oh, salmon's so good.
That's why lacto ovo pescatarian. I don't need the ovo. I don't like eggs.
I love eggs.
I don't even like them.
Eggs and ramen.
Yeah. Oh, God, the way they do that in the bowl.
Yeah, the eggs and ramen are delicious.
That's so fucking good. It is.
You can't, like, deny that.
That's really good. I don't deny it.
Yeah. The eggs and ramen is the bomb.
Did we get any sweets from the
no? I need G-Man.
No, I didn't get any sweets.
Okay. G-Man now. Well,
you did good.
Revy the house elf donated $5 through Super Chat. The good old days when Master actually handed me food instead of making me beg for it, then slap me for taking it, crying.
I'm glad that we could help you through this traumatic period. Thank you very much.
For us.
I got a bunch.
I'm at 172.
You know what? I bet William would like this.
I'm at 172 even, folks. Mm-hmm.
Then they think of the kids at the end. They think, what should we keep? What should we throw out? You know what? I think at least one of the kids deserves to eat.
awesome.
Uh-huh. Fuck Zach.
I only got 12 pounds left.
Really?
Yep. But the last 10 is like nothing.
I'll give that to William. Here, you're going to want those. To Naaman.
Oh, my God. Yes,
you're going to want that to Naaman.
I have my chips.
Yep.
I have chips. Where are my chips? I have my chips, and I got pita breads. It's so delicious. Nick, you're the best. We love you. We're going to see you soon.
Oh, my gosh. Collabing with Nikado Avocado.
I can't wait, man.
Can you imagine doing that with Nikado Avocado? Just.
I love Nick.
I do, too.
I think he's one of the nicest individuals on the internet.
Absolutely.
Genuinely nice individual. Yeah, please clean my
I am.
You're so beautiful white. You're a perfect white. Why don't you tell the folks about the thing you got for... That's in front of you, Shandy, that we put together today. That you're so excited about. You should tell them about it, at least. No?
Yeah.
That's my tray.
I should.
Uh-huh. I'm going to get you. You should tell them about it.
Yeah, I have this, like, really cool, like, medical tray now that'll make life a lot more easier. It's got drawers on it.
Can I devour this, Shannon? Because I really love it.
Go ahead, baby.
It's a trough. Okay, we're talking to people who had a spice rack and cooking utensils in their fucking washroom off the bedroom. Okay, this is... Folks, let's just move ahead. Let's just move ahead.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Hey, okay. Girl.
So you may be wondering why another Tila tequila video. So one, as I've been talking about, Tila has been going off the deep end. I mean, even today she's been putting up videos and she's going at war with these women, right? That, you know, had got her channel in trouble before. So this one, she really tells it like it is. According to her, the Bible tells these women to shut the fuck up. So we'll see if she can back that up with scripture. And I assure you, it has absolutely nothing to do with the fact that her boobies look absolutely anyways in this video. It had nothing to do with that, folks. It was just a happy coincidence. Gotta give credit where credit's due. Gotta give credit where credit's due.
Undefeated champion of the world. Hold on, let me see. Oh, hi guys. Look how cute I am. Everyone wishes they were me, the original and only baby girl. It's so funny, like, ever since I released Judgment to these haughty women of Zion, and they're getting exposed, now all of a sudden there's this big group of, like, pick me hoes. We see through you. See, they're scared. They don't want to get exposed as one of these haughty women of Zion. So they pretend they jump ships. And now they're pretending they're sitting up there, like, you know, making reaction videos, judging other women, and, like, looking down on them. Like, listen, I'm different because I'm literally Queen Esther. Okay, look. I'm literally... Where's my boo thing? I'm literally his wife. Look, we even look the same. I mean, Jesus, even he has never aged. Ever since you learned about Jesus thousands of years ago, he should be like hundreds of million years old. But y'all only know him as like 30 years old. He never ages either.
Yeah, because he died.
So neither do I look. We literally look like the cutest couple. We match. I'm so beautiful. Oh my God. So anyway, so these hoes, they're like pick me hoes, you know. So they're trying to be like, oh, I'm nothing like those girls. And this one hoe, she deliberately, because you know how I talk about them, like, having no daddy having ass hoes, you know? So this bitch literally was so thirsty, she posted a picture with her and her dad. Oh, okay, good for you. You want a cookie now? Like, they're so thirsty, desperate, pick-me hoes. So, and the thing is, they're not even Christian. And now there's another group of them arising talking about, oh, I'm a virgin. I'm waiting for marriage. Look what I just started. Look what I just started with my boo thing. See, that's us kissing. That's literally me. Look at that. We have the same hairline and everything. But, you know, these hoes are lying. That's why God says, believe not every spirit, but test these hoes. Test them. But even now, it's over for them anyways. You know, it's over. So now they're already scared. I mean, when the light of God shines on you, you cannot hide. They're trying to hide, turn into pick-me hoes. You know, sitting up there trying to shapeshift. They're literally reptilian shapeshifters. Don't trust these hoes, my sons. Stay far away from them. You know, they're all these haughty women of Zion getting exposed. And now they're like pick-me hoes. I mean, it's just really, really bad out there, guys. They all wish they were me. Oh, look how cute and young I am. Look at my perky breasts. Oh, yeah, by the way, you hoes need to learn how to shut the fuck up. These hoes, they ain't nothing worse than a Karen coming up in here. Nobody fucking invited you. You know, the worst type of women are one, the ones who don't know how to shut the fuck up. The Bible literally says, women, shut the fuck up, okay? It says, be quiet, you know, have a quiet, teachable spirit. So, otherwise, in other words, shut the fuck up. These bitches always coming over. Look, I don't even have my comment section open, but they find a way to spew their opinions. You know, it's the ugliest thing for an old hag to come to a young woman's page, a married young woman, to spew your, you know, opinions. You know, it's like nobody fucking asks you. Imagine waking up every day, making your coffee, you know. Oh, today's going to be a great day, guys. And then some Karen knocks on your door and starts spewing out her opinions. Nobody fucking asked you. So shut the fuck up. These women are real bad, guys. So don't even feel bad for them. They deserve everything that's coming their way. They're aging, old, they think they're all that, they ain't shit, you ain't shit. Learn how to shut the fuck up. The Bible says submit, shut the fuck up, and be quiet. Don't even speak in the church. Don't even preach in the church, because it is shameful for a woman to do such things. And the reason why I have the mentality of a man, and I know how man thinks, because I'm Mulan, bro. I'm Mulan. My father raised me like this. He taught me to fight like a man. But you hoes, just shut the fuck up and do everyone a favor. Shut the fuck up!
We'll be right back after these messages.
My hair.
Yeah?
Morning, all. Vaughn Hilton still don't have lights, it looks like. Okay. It must mean all of us Frost are going to jail. That's fine. You know, he says he's putting everybody in jail for elderly abuse. Well, Uncle Jim could put him in jail for elderly abuse, slandering his name. Ronnie Ray can get him for slandering about him being a tanker. He was never a tanker. Ronnie was the tanker. James Vaughn Hilton, why don't you just quit lying to people and start being truthful to everybody? And you might make a friend or two. J-Dub? You know who I am, LF. You got something to say to me? You can go live with me anytime you're ready, buddy, old pal. I always like new friends. Not going to stay on here long. I just wanted people to know his electricity was off. He was given the money to pay his bills. And instead of paying his light bill, he went and bought food. But if he goes down to the church, he could have got free food. But he must not like that food. You know, when I was growing up, you pay your bills and then you worry about where the food is. I can go to my neighbor's and eat. I can't get my neighbor to pay my light bill. And sorry, Irvy, I wasn't sixth grade. It was ninth grade. But I'm still smarter than you. My son taking your mom's money to go to college. Well, does that mean I can send you the bill? Because right now he is $12,000 behind for the first year. So you got to keep running your mouth. That's fine. If anyone goes to jail, it's going to be you, buddy, not no one else. So enjoy your time with no electricity. Enjoy the fun because it's got a lot more coming. Thank you. Y'all have a good day.
All right. So this was posted on YouTube a few days ago. Now, we do have a newest update. Sock account did post this in Trolls, Haters, Naysayers Discord. I have the picture up currently. Just give me a second, folks. I will enhance it. So apparently, Von Helton has access to at least some form of internet. Some limited capacity somewhere. Because as of Tuesday, 10:38 a.m., apparently, he was quite concerned. If you can't read it, folks, I'll read what it says here. He was responding to this person. Well, there still isn't any titty-sucking animations. Also, old animations that have the player and dog meat. If you're not familiar with who dog meat is, that's the name of a dog in a video game. Also, old animations that have the player and dog meat having sex with an NPC are no longer compatible, it seems. Crying face. Folks. Von Helton is concerned that there still isn't any titty sucking going on in this animation, and also old animations like gangbanging an NPC with your pet dog is not working. You can't script it, folks. That's right from the horse's vagina right there. So if you've been wondering what Von Helton's been up to, apparently no good. And that was a sock account that braved the dark web to bring us that. Aye, aye, aye. So Von Helton still largely without electricity as far as I'm aware. Where he's getting access. Does he have a extension cord running to Moz? Where is he, you know? Oh, folks, these are questions that we need answers. And we'll work on that. But I thought for tonight we would round it out with a little romp through an unlisted playlist that I like to call Von Helton's Abuse, or Von's Abuse. And let's just take a walk down memory lane. Let me get it ready here. Yeah, Von Abuse.
So under jobs...
We've seen that one. So I thought... It may be apropos to start with Von Helton's, and I know many of you have seen this. If you're new, you haven't, so this will be a treat. Von Helton's first ever official YouTube video. Oh boy, he didn't know what he was getting himself into. Von Helton does have teeth in this video clip, and from there, folks, we take a walk down memory lane of perhaps some of Von Helton's darkest memories. I mean, there are so many. These are the classics.
Greetings, Covert Conservatives. This is Baron Von Helton, and since I can't come to you in D.C. or New York, I thought that I would bring you to me. Here's my newest addition, Smokey, the Ninja Cat, who is just had what was left of a TV dinner. And I just thought I would give you a shout out and see how this thing works. I probably have the cheapest webcam on the face of the planet, but I got it working, amazingly enough, so we'll see how everything works out. Thanks, and have a pleasant day.
Here, CPS is my heroes. Oh yeah, they saved my kids from that evil Von Helton guy, only to take them to fucking Aruba, where they get on a ship and go to Saudi Arabia to be some fucking sheikh's sex slave. Yeah, that's really helping the kids. Good job, guys. You really helped my kids, putting them in the fucking kiddie porn. Yeah, that's really helping them. You dumb son of a bitches. Why do you think all these kids go missing every year, dummies? Think! And I've got a doctor, off record, who told me, showed me, give me the docket for when these ships come in to take these kids off. I've got it in my possession. I'm not going to show it. Fuck no, I ain't showing it. Hell no.
Hold it.
I think we're going to pry stuff in.
Yeah. I got stuff that they shouldn't be taking.
But yeah, it wasn't the pain. It wasn't the Advil, and the doctor said the kid could take a whole bottle of Advil, won't hurt him a bit. It wasn't the Advil. It was a nasty stomach bug. See, that's what threw us all. It even threw the doctor last night. Not last night. The previous night that it occurred, because the doctor was like, "Well, it ain't the Advil. There's nothing wrong. There's nothing in Advil that could, you know, cause this to occur." And you know, I'm like, "What?" He's like, "Yeah, man. You could take the whole damn bottle of Advil. Won't hurt you a bit." And he's like, "Oh, well. You know, I didn't know that. I didn't know Advil was that harmless." But apparently it is. So it had to be something else, and we're all scratching our heads wondering what the heck was going on. Well, it ended up being a nasty stomach bug. A really, really nasty, virulent strain of stomach virus.
And it's like, I just get online there, and people are DMing me saying, Von Helton, let his kids get your Anvil painkillers, and she could take it, Lyell, I could take the hospital, and I'm like, what the fuck?
No.
I just thought, like, actually, like, what's this all about?
No. Mom left the bottle off the Advil. The kid got a hold of the Advil. But it, like I said, the doctor said she could have took the whole damn bottle. It wouldn't have hurt her a bit. Wouldn't have hurt her one bit. So,
that's
no.
That's good, but you always got to check, man. You always
got to
take
it. Oh, yeah. You know, like I said, as soon as I found her with the bottle, it's like, phew, you know, we're off to the hospital, right?
How does it spell
the
A-D-V-I-L?
A-D-V...
I know how you feel at the heck of the hospital. I'm going to tell you the story. When I had my oldest grandson, when my son's first wife left him and our first grandson was probably 6 months old or so, give or take. She just walked out on him, just flat walked out.
Mm-hmm.
And so we moved him to our house. And what happened, there's this lady who was taking care of the grandchild for our son while he was working. And the next call we got was from the hospital emergency room.
Mm-hmm.
And our son, and the kid was in the high school emergency room, and they took him up to Santa Barbara, up to they call it Cottage Hospital, where they have our specialists. Somebody had shook him and literally threw him in the crib in the corner as hard as they could. The impact was that of an automobile accident on his head. He almost didn't make it. It was the babysitter that we knew it. Everybody knew it. I mean, certainly wasn't my son. He was working, but he was one of the suspects. So. What they did to begin with, is they gave custody to the mother. Yeah, you know, she was not ready to have, you know, to keep that child.
Mm-hmm.
She was all mixed up kid. She made it one night, called up here and said, you either come down and get your kid, I'm going to leave him here, but I'm going to go check to see my dad. Well, here was with her Iraqi stepfather and her Iraqi mother. We talked her into bringing the kid up here. We got an emergency order for us to be responsible for the grandchild. But after that, every time any little thing happened, the poor kid bumps his head on an end table. Oh, my God, we got to take him to the doctor's office. What are they going to think now? Well, we took him to my doctor's office, through noses, and said, don't worry about it, I'm just going to report this, I know better, you didn't beat the kid. But, you know, it took a while to get my son cleared from that.
Right.
He couldn't even stay in a house with us. He had to stay at one of our friends' house for the longest time before he could even be around that child.
But see, here's the thing. If he was at work, and there was people that could verify that he was at work, that should have cleared him of any, you know, I'm not getting that. I'm not understanding how somebody at work could have possibly also been home and throwing the kid around. I mean, that's...
She had one child, and she had a temper tantrum. She went off. She did it. There's no doubt in anybody's mind she did it.
Yeah.
She got a sharp lawyer. She lost her kid for a while. And here...
Oh, yesterday.
The Lord of mercy, son.
Yesterday's pizza.
It's got gnats and everything.
No, it does not have gnats in it. Jesus Christ.
Please take it to the kitchen. I'll take it in the room. And put your dirty napkins in the garbage. This is exactly... why that you got your children took away from.
No, Mom, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
There was no mention of the house at all. Sorry. There wasn't no mention of the house at all. Sorry. You fail. Once again, you fail. There was no mention of the fucking house. No mention of the fucking house at all. The home is cluttered to the point that it is difficult to find a place to sit, and the surfaces, i.e. countertops, tables, coffee table, etc., are covered with dirty dishes, dirty bottles, and other stuff. You will have to describe in detail what occurred in my home to cause my children to be at risk. Then request the court to order the release of the records. Well, yeah, if I want to wait until they decide to do it. On 8-9-2011, the children were seen at the UK Grad Clinic and were once again diagnosed as failure to thrive. Their formula was changed, however, despite several prompts from worker, had not contacted the WIC program to obtain the new formula. The parents seemed to be lackadaisical in the care of Jeremiah and the twin, as well as their older sibling, Layla. The parents had been observed feeding their children out of dirty bottles. The twins were often left to cry it out in their bed. They have been found in feces and urine on a regular basis. Layla is often left in the high chair or swing for hours at a time without any interaction. Wrong. Layla's left in the high chair in the swing to watch Fox News and her weather channel, which, by the way, she dearly loves. Children are receiving very little nurturing, despite the fact that I took my kids to Golden Corral the other day. Oh, wait. Yeah, well, yeah, I guess if you take your kids to Golden Corral, that's not nurturing, right, guys? Right? Mother appears to have some intellectual limitations. In other words, they're saying Andrea is stupid. It has been reported but not verified that the father is diagnosed schizophrenic. The father, James, has boasted he has multiple weapons in the home, including knives and loaded guns, which include an SKS assault rifle. Haha, I wish. And a handgun. These weapons are allow them to protect themselves from the aliens that will be invading Earth as soon, as well as the haters. The HANDS program was working with the family in the home, but have now withdrawn due to potential risk of harm to the worker. The home is cluttered to the point that it is difficult to find a place to sit, and the surfaces, i.e. countertops, tables, coffee table, etc., are covered with dirty dishes, dirty bottles, and other stuff. The family has no income. They are dependent on James's 83-year-old mother who lives next door to them. The children are at risk of harm due to the parents' failure to meet their needs. I saw neglect of not just the two infants, but also of the one-year-old baby as well. She was left in her high chair for the entire 2.5 hours I was in the home for the first visit, and in the 2-hour second visit as well, other than when the 82-year-old grandmother got her out. The 82-year-old grandmother lives next door and helps all she can, but she is only able to do so much. The mother is more concerned about herself than the baby. When SN tried to teach her about infant care, she would change the subject to herself. Baby's charged for the hospital's stay, and the SN notes speak for themselves. The babies gained weight while in the hospital, at least 1 ounce per day of each of them. When they got home, they lost weight. The infants are 6 weeks old and have gained no weight since coming home. They both had a rash when admitted to the hospital. The mother stated that she stopped holding the other baby when she turned 6 months old. When SN arrived for a home visit, the parents went to bed and left SN to feed and clothe the babies. The infants were totally covered in feces and urine. Said the infants were totally covered in feces and urine. Father was throwing up due to the fact that the infants were covered in feces. No. Again, home visit notes and hospital records speak for themselves. The baby's weight gain of 1 ounce per day while in the hospital shows they can thrive if placed in a better environment. Note from hospital stated that the parents were feeding babies clabbered milk in MD office during visit and was not aware it was spoiled, refused to feed babies in hospital, always had the reason that the nurses had to feed them. I feel the babies will suffer if left in the current home situation, possible life endangerment with dehydration and failure to thrive.
You can't even kick CPS out of your house. Hey, watching Vaughn, we all been watching. They coming for those kids. I got evidence. You piece of shit. But anyway, when is that court case, Vaughn? You need witnesses. I was thinking about driving up there to Manchester, Kentucky. You know, it's only about 6 hours from here. But I'm willing to make that day trip just to go to court as a witness for the state. Oh, yeah. When is that case? Next month, Vaughn. Get up with me. Leave me the details for court next month.
Give me a thumbs up if you're American. Well, Texan, whatever. Okay, good. Good. Yes, that's good. That's good to know. All right, all you Americans, I want to show you what Mark Gronin costed you. See that? See all this bullshit? See how thick these papers are? That's what Mark Gronin, Jay Stevio, and all them fucks over in Europe are costing you. Hundreds of thousands of dollars. These are court summons, folks. These are court summons. Costing you thousands of dollars. Out of your pocket. Out of your pocket. Mark Gronin, Jay Stevio, and all them people over in Europe calling CPS, call the police. Costing you thousands of dollars. Look how thick that is. Look how thick that is. Thousands and thousands of dollars out of your pocket as an American. On felonious calls to CPS and to the police. Do you understand? Do you understand? So you need to go and you need to find their YouTube pages and you need to flag all their videos. Because they're costing you money. It's costing you money out of your pocket. Every time they call CPS, every time they call the police, every time they make a false report, it's costing you thousands of dollars out of your pocket. Here's the papers right here. There they are. There's the papers right here. We just got them. That's what the mailman was doing. He just handed them to us. Yet another felonious court case. Costing you, the American taxpayer, thousands of dollars at the hands of a bunch of fucking YouTube haters. Okay, it's costing you thousands of dollars, folks. Thousands. Alright. Look how thick that shit is. Look at this shit. Look how thick it is, man. Look how thick that shit is. Every time they call CPS out here, that's costing you thousands of dollars. Every time they call the police, costing you thousands of dollars. Every time we got to go to court, it's costing you thousands of dollars. Yes, but what are they trying to say? I'll just read one of them. Well, it says remain in the home. So... must not be too bad.
Oh, wait till you read more.
Oh, really? Folks, right here, 100 G's, man.
Let me talk.
Go talk.
I'm trying to make it look like we didn't do much in the battle
at all. Yeah, well, that's okay. I'll just bring Mom up. Mom will verify that we treated the wounds.
I can say what. Left it clean?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's not all I said.
They said we did not apply appropriate first aid. Well, that's a lie. We did. And we did not give her to a babysitter. That too is a lie. Mm-hmm. See, these fuckers lie. These fuckers lie. When they filed this out, they bold-faced lied to the court. They should all go to jail for perjury, but none of them do. That's not right, man.
Oh, you already know what the website's on. He didn't think they're above the law just because they're social workers.
That's right. They think they're above the law. That was a senator said that. A senator said DCBS thinks they're above the law.
Well, they're not. They're regular people just like everybody else.
We don't call them CPS here in Kentucky. We call them DCBS. Same thing, but that's we call them DCBS here in Kentucky. But they lied. They lied on this court document. They said that we applied no first aid of any kind, and that we left them with a babysitter. Well, we never left them with a babysitter. We didn't leave them with a babysitter, and we did apply first aid. That's a bold-faced lie. Oh, no more anonymous reports. I've already spoke to some legislatures here in Kentucky, and I am going to be filing a brief with the Kentucky State Senate. No more anonymous callers, okay? If you call CPS, you will have to give your name, your address, your phone number. It will have to be publicly listed. And it must be factual in every way. If any of your statement or your location or your name or your date of birth, whatever, if any of it is false, it will be considered a false report and charges will be levied against you, not against me. Are we all clear on that shit? I've already talked to the senators here in Kentucky. I've already talked to them. There will be no more anonymous calling. You will have to give your name, your address, your phone number. You will have to describe in detail what occurred in my home to cause my children to be at risk. There will be no more anonymous calls. That's done. I've already took care of that shit. It is done. On December 28, 2011, DCBS received an anonymous report. Yeah, well, that's gone. There's no more anonymous reports. All right. Okay, it even says in their own report that I treated the wound. They contradicted themselves right in their own fucking report, dumbasses. What idiots. Alice stated that when she changed her diaper, she found a burn on Helena's body and immediately called her son. She stated that Mr. James Von Helden reported to her that he surfed the internet to obtain advice for treating a burn and found a site that told him to put a potato on it. He later made the same statement to DCBS staff.
So, that's not illegal.
Treating your children at home, folks, is not a crime. Okay, treating your children at home is not a crime. Of course, they're going to make it a crime because they want you to take every emergency to the emergency room. They don't want you to treat things by yourself. Which, by the way, costs even more thousands of dollars. So they contradicted themselves on their own fucking report. Because in the beginning it says, oh, well, Von Helton didn't treat the wound. Obviously, Von Helton did treat the wound with a raw potato. Okay, so they lied in their own fucking document. They contradicted their own fucking documents, the fools. Helena and her siblings were transported to the doctor only after they were strongly encouraged by DCBS. No, I was threatened by a police officer with arrest. For my own children, folks, threatened arrest for if I didn't take my children to the emergency room. Okay? Keep that in mind. It'll be important later. It was not 47 degrees outside. That was a lie. It was 35 degrees outside. They said it was 47. It was not, folks. It was only 35 degrees. It was freezing outside. Go back to the Weather Channel and look at the dates. It was 35. They lied again. On an official court document, folks, they're lying. Okay? These are official court documents and CPS is lying. Okay? On official court documents, they are lying. They're all guilty of perjury, folks. Folks, if you lie on a legal document, it's felony. It's a felony. You're not supposed to lie on legal documents, but CPS is doing it every day, all day. After the visit, it was also reported the children were not gaining weight. stated that the children had only gained an ounce in roughly 1 month. Did you know, folks, that premature babies don't start really gaining weight till after their first year? Did you know that? Remember that, too. It'll be important later. Record that, haters. The children that are preemies don't start really gaining serious weight until after 1 year. What?
I picked somebody up and they were in a troll.
Oh. Somebody was accidentally kicked. Come on back in. 15 minutes. Oh, and by the way, folks, if they're gaining one or two ounces a day, like they're trying to say, the baby is critically overweight. The baby would be overweight. Or 1 to 2 ounces per week. Well, that still would be an overweight child. Okay? That still would be overweight. Why are they so eager to have my child be overweight? Something to think about. Something that will be probably asked in a court of law, by the way. Nurse practitioner Smith did not say it was second degree burns.
Exactly.
Because if it had been second degree burns, the child would have been rushed to the emergency room. The parents reported to the nurse that they did not seek treatment for the child in an attempt to conceal the injury from DCBS staff. That's a fucking lie.
Yeah, it is.
That is a bold-faced lie. We never said nothing of the kind. Oh, I am so gonna burn these fuckers this time. You thought the last two court cases was an easy win? This is going to be a fucking easy win and a half. Why wasn't the kid immediately transported to the emergency room, folks? If the kid was in a life-threatening situation, it would have been transported to the emergency room.
Exactly.
Hello? Yeah, but it wasn't. Okay, I'm so going to burn them on this shit. I am so going to win this court case. Manchester Pediatrics are gathering medical records. They're not supposed to be. Manchester Pediatrics. Oh, by the way, they lied about Dr. Irwin. Yeah, we were told Dr. Irwin had a practice in Kentucky.
Don't.
Turns out he doesn't have a fucking practice in Kentucky. He's a legitimate doctor, and he does work in Kentucky, but he only does a little bit of work in the hospital every now and then. He didn't even have a practice. They lied. They lied about Dr. Irwin. Fucking crazy. These people lie at the drop of a hat, folks. They lie at the drop of a hat and drop it themselves. So Manchester Pediatrics isn't even supposed to be seeing my children. I'm trying to get my children to a facility away from Manchester Pediatrics. And once again, the weight of the children does not start normalizing until after 1 year in premature babies.
We already brought that out in court
the last time, but apparently they didn't get the memo. So now we're going to bring it out in court again. Premature children do not stabilize their weight gaining until after 1 year of age.
Platy donated $4.99 through Super Chat. It's odd he keeps saying the kid and not his child's name.
Very odd indeed. Welcome to the world of Von Helton. He usually addresses them plurally as goddamn kids.
Age. 1 year. And my two twins are not 1 year old yet. They're only 6 months. They apparently didn't get the memo the first time, so we're going to slam them on that shit too. They said the children are not feeding properly. Well, if the children are not being fed, why am I going through hundreds of diapers every month?
They spit up bad steel.
And they still spit up a little bit too, but that's immaterial. We're going through too many diapers for us not to be feeding the children. So that's easily dismissed.
That's the last straw.
Yeah, this is the last straw. We're going to sue after this. I'm done with this shit. We're suing after this. Manchester Pediatrics is not in my home. Manchester Pediatrics is an office, and not even a very large office, where some doctors and nurse practitioners and nurse's aides work. They're not even in my home. That's another lie. Okay? That's another lie, folks.
What, they say that?
Yeah, it says it. It says Manchester Pediatrics is in the home.
Well, that's a lie.
Of course it's a lie.
Oh, so they the building just automatically moved it.
Apparently,
right next to it.
Yeah, apparently Manchester Pediatrics just moved right next door to us or some shit. Yeah. What the fuck, man? Bunch of lies. Nothing but lies.
It must be nice to get paid a lot, don't it? But is it worth it? I don't think so.
The cabinet, along with nurse practitioner Susan Smith, believes the Von Helton family needs services provided inside of this home in order to relieve the stress of caring for three children under the age of two. No, dumbass. We have stress because you fuckers are marching through our house with armed police officers every fucking time we turn around. That's what we need stress from. Dumbasses. Get the fuck out of my house and stay out of my house. That's how you relieve my stress. I'm stressed out when I have armed police officers traipsing through my house on Christmas Eve. I have stress when I have police officers threatening to throw me in jail simply because I don't know what the fuck is going on my fucking property. That is what causes stress. Now let's see if we can catch him in some more lies.
I'm sure you will.
A prevention plan was offered to Mr. Von Helton. Okay, folks, when you hear the word prevention plan, think Nazi Germany. To stay with a relative until we completed our investigations. Okay, my wife is overwhelmed. Yes, my wife is overwhelmed because the CPS makes rules that cannot possibly be followed. Then when you don't follow the rules as they outline them, then they go whining to the judge and say, Judge, they couldn't keep our rules. You got to take their kids away. But see, the rules they make could not possibly be followed. If I had 30 people in this home, I could not possibly keep the rules that CPS wants me to keep. Okay? There's no way. Fully staffed hospitals could not keep the rules that CPS wants kept. All right. They made a call to the family drug pharmacy. They did not give me time to get to the... And by the way, I already talked to the judge about this. Mm-hmm. The judge knows that I had the medication in my car. So that's another fucking lie.
Anyway, we're going to go to the hospital. Right, honey?
Correct. Which we did, by the way.
Yep.
You don't need to seek emergency treatment, folks, if it's not necessary. And at the time, it was not necessary, and it's still not necessary, really.
You didn't know there were blisters there.
That's right. Right. It did. The skin did not blister. But see, the thing of it is, you can still have a first-degree burn and have a blister or two. Okay? Second-degree burn is where the skin is really charred bad. And the skin was not charred bad. It was red, but it was not charred. Okay? And then, of course, third-degree burn is where it burns all the way through to the muscle tissue. But, you know, but yeah, we're gonna pwn them on this shit too. So, you know, get ready to lose DCBS because you're gonna lose. Caught you lying in a court on court documents. That's a felony. That's a felony. And this time I'm gonna make the felony stick. I'm gonna make the felony stick this time. You committed a felony. You lied on court documents. That is a felony. 5 years in jail, and I'm going to make it stick this time because I'm going to contact the court myself. And I'm going to insist that everybody that had a party to this and committed a felony on legal court documents, be charged with a felony and arrested. You're going to jail. I'm tired of this shit. Tired of this fucking bullshit. Sit there and lie their fucking ass off. And no problem whatsoever. They can lie, perjure themselves in court. They lied to that judge. Told that judge that kid was dying. That kid wasn't dying. I'm sorry, it just wasn't dying. They go lie to the judge, tell the judge the kid's dying. Oh my God, judge, the kid's dying. It's so horrible, judge. No, had nothing wrong with the kid. Had a little bit of red on his chest, a little bit of red on the leg. We treated it. By the way, the red on the leg and the chest, it's gone. It's gone. It's gone, folks. It's gone. No, it's not second degree. No. What caused the red? A little bit of water. A little bit of hot water. Well, exactly my point, pretty Paula. And that's why we did not rush the kid to the emergency room, because...
If I really wanted to hurt her, I could have done worse than that.
Yeah, it was bathtub water.
Right, honey?
Yes. Would it help if my fans called the judge? Actually, you could probably get in trouble for that. Just... Yeah, a little bit of water caused the burn. Yeah, they make duckies that change color if the water's too hot. We know about that now. But see, water that does not feel hot to us may be hot to the child. Well, they're saying that warm water is caused a second degree burn, which is total bullshit, because it didn't. Yeah, the water would have to be literally boiling to cause a second or third degree burn. And it was not, obviously. I wouldn't get... the thing about calling the judge is that if you called the judge, you could actually go to jail for interfering in a court case. Yeah. I would not do that if I were you.
I mean,
yeah, it's a nice thought, but I wouldn't do it, because you could actually go to jail over that. The thing you can do, I'll tell you what you should do. What you should do is call Manchester Police and tell them that these haters on YouTube are lying about me, that you've watched my shows on YouTube and on Blog TV. You've seen me go back, get up out of my chair and go back and check on my kids. You've seen me bring the kids and hold them in front of the camera. You've seen that the kids are not in any danger. You've seen me playing with my kids. You've seen videos of my kids. And you just call Manchester Police and say, hey man, you know, use the haters' own video against them. The haters all have YouTube videos out there saying, call Manchester Police. Well, call them and tell them, I watched the same Blog TV show. The kids are not being abused. The kids are not being life-threatening. The kids are not in any danger. Von Helton is not a killer. Von Helton is not trying to harm his children. These haters have to be ignored. And then hang up the phone. Well, now, if you testify in court, that will help. That will help me. Yes. If you're willing to come up and stand next to me in front of that judge, that would be a big help. Yes. But flagging their videos and contacting YouTube and having their channels removed would be an even bigger help, I think. Well, Gary, the problem is that the airfare is, for you would be thousands of dollars, and I ain't got it. I ain't got it, man. He's wanting me to pay his airfare from across the pond, and I ain't got that kind of money, man. Yeah, that's right. I mean, how many people have played with their kids on YouTube, on Blog TV, Live Leak?
Hey, what if they put little cameras on?
I mean, there's fucking... There's people on Facebook playing with their kids, talking to their kids, having fun with their kids. Ain't nobody on their ass, but they all on me. Why? Why? I did take them to Golden Corral. I took them to my kids have been all...
No, technically, not that Golden Corral should be any kind of standard, but just to correct the record again, you didn't take them anywhere. It was Andrea's mother visiting, took the family to Golden Corral. You shot a video proving that the kids were being treated like Golden Corral was some golden standard. And the whole video, the kids never once had food in front of them. They were in high chairs at the time. Folks, the update, if you're coming late on Von Helton, we played a little bit of Larry Frost. We played a screenshot that I have up just above the folks' glass. Look up. That's the latest from Von Helton. As I understand it, at the residence, technically he's still without electricity. But somehow he's got internet access and electricity to some extent somewhere, because he's been posting that he's still very disappointed that there are no titty-sucking animations and he can't do gangbangs with... he's been complaining about dog meat for years now. That's interesting. Let's move ahead, folks. Let's move beyond this. Let's move here. All right.
But, yeah.
Something a little more modern. So this was from the infamous Sister Sunshine interviews. This was when Von Helton dared suggest that he was going to homeschool his children. This, of course, is on the heels of, I believe, number 11 or number 12. But this is, they've never come home since. They've never recovered since this. Folks, thank you for watching. Please remember to thumbs up and all that good stuff.
Yeah, Jerry and Helena and Layla, I'm going to be homeschooling them. CPS decided to pay me a visit on Thanksgiving Eve, where I've got a phone in one hand and I've got a chicken in the other hand, and I'm trying to, you know, make plans on a calendar and with a hand I don't even have. And you know, here comes CPS to muddy the waters. And
why did they come?
Yeah, the kids weren't wearing new clothes, and their clothes were dirty and they smelled, and they hadn't washed their hair, and all this, which was a total lie, of course. Mm-hmm. But Thanksgiving Eve, and the CPS worker actually messed up, because she was telling me about how they went in and spoke to my kids and stuff, and I'm like, oh really, you did you? You know, and but yeah, went right into school, talked with them at school without my consent, you know, and I'm like, okay. So I've yanked my kids out of school, and I'm going to homeschool them from now on.
Don't you think that might increase the odds of Child Protective Services being concerned about your kids? I mean,
no,
they do have the right legally, I think, to talk to interview children.
Yes, if there is a problem of some kind, but there is no problem. Okay, my divorce was years ago. That's all done. That's all settled. In the 9.5 years that they've harassed the shit out of me, my kids have never been harmed. No laws have ever been broken. Okay, so no, they don't have the right. The government does not have the right to just come in and take your kids out of school. Okay, they can't do that. All right, not only that, but every time they take them out of a class, guess what? That's an F. Your kid gets an F for that day. All right. So no, the government doesn't have the right to do that. All right. And I noticed my kids' grades were failing. They were bringing home Fs. I'm like, what in the world is this? My kids are straight A students. What the heck's going on? They were taking them out of class, ask them a bunch of questions, just whenever they want, just whenever they felt like, just waltzing right in there and pulling them out. And to hell with that. So I'm homeschooling my kids effective immediately. If they don't like it, they can go fly kite. Because that's just the way it's going to be. But the government does not have the whole point. I explained this to the people at the school, too, because the people at the school didn't know. The whole point of a constitution, folks, is to limit the government's ability to attack an individual or a family. Mm-hmm. That's the whole point of the constitution. Okay, so if the government has unfettered access to your kids in a public school, what's the point of even having a constitution? The Constitution has basically been made null and void at that point. If the government can go into school and yank your kids out of class any old time they want, you ain't got a Constitution. You don't. Because the whole purpose of a Constitution is to limit the government's ability against the citizen. That's the whole point of it. That's why the Constitution was made. All right. And it doesn't matter whether it's a Kentucky state constitution or the federal constitution. It doesn't matter. Okay, but it's a limitation on the government's ability to harass, harangue, assault, jail, kill the average individual citizen. That's the whole point of it. Anyway, back to the topic at hand. Yeah, the government does not have a right to come and get your kids whenever they want. They'll say they do. They will tell you flat to your face. They'll look you right now and say, we can come and get your kids out of school anytime we want. That's a flat out lie. It's a flat out lie. They can't. They have to be able to prove that the child is in danger, or that there is some kind of, you know, altercation occurring, a divorce, settlement, dispute of some kind. There has to be a reason, okay? They can't just waltz in there any old time they like and yank your kid out of school, okay? They can't do that. That's BS.
Well, I mean, I'm going to give you some heartfelt advice here, Vaughn. I think it's taking them out of school may trigger more focus, I guess, if you will. On,
I've had 9.5 years of focus. They can't be no more focus than that.
If you do choose to homeschool your kids still, I would recommend actually that you put them in maybe a charter school with a home study program where they go mm-hmm. see the teacher once a week, mm-hmm. you know, so that way it's state approved.
I'm going to be handling it through the Board of Education and everything. So,
yeah,
it's all going to be handled through the Board of Education. GVR says, or GY6, is that GY6 or GVR? Anyway, GY6 says lots of hoops to jump through when homeschooling, Bun. You have to be very careful and keep precise records. Yeah, well, I know what they can do with their records, right? I'm still the parent, and the government is not the parent. I'm the parent. And like Andy Cap says, we do still have rights in this country, and I intend to exercise those rights. And if they decide to pursue it, then we'll have to deal with it in court then, you know, because it's all going to court anyway. I mean, they drove my wife insane, destroyed my marriage, and abused my kids under foster care. So we're going to court anyway. Wow. All right. So if they dogpile on more in addition to that, it's just going to look better in my favor.
My heartfelt advice to you is, I mean, even though I understand, you know, that you're feeling upset, you know, with them taking your kids out of class and all that. But I mean, ultimately, it's a good idea to pretty much cooperate, you know, and do what CPS says. If they make you take parenting classes or anything like that, you know, I would cooperate, right? Because the more you fight, they do have the power of the state, you know, behind them. And, you know, ultimately, I mean, sure, ultimately, both you and they want the best interest of the child.
No, they don't, honey. Let me stop you right there, okay? Government's main purpose is to destroy the family. They want to destroy the family unit. Now, why is that? They want to destroy the family unit because a family unit is very hard to control.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so they want to destroy the family unit. That is the purpose of Child Protective Services. That is the purpose of DCBS, whatever you wish to call it in your state. You know, that's the whole purpose of it, is to destroy the family unit, because governments historically have been very hard to control families. They can't control them. Okay, so what do? They get the family busted up and get you all back to individuals again. Then it's real easy to control you then at that point. Okay, so no, they don't give a rip about your family. You know, when they got my kids, when they come out to me on Christmas Day and took my kids, they shipped them clear out to Indiana, where they ended up getting abused. Now, admittedly, they didn't get abused by the foster parents. They got abused by the foster parents' daughter and their daughter's boyfriend. But still, they shipped them clear out to Indiana, where they ended up getting abused. Okay, they don't care. They don't care. There was no inquiry. There was no investigation. There was no arrest made. Nothing was done. Okay. They do not care. They really don't. All they see is potential dollar signs. Can this kid get me $3,000 ahead? You know, can I get, $3,000 out of this kid by putting it in an adoptive home or something? That's the only thing that matters to them. They don't care about family units. They could care less. Well, here's the thing. Okay. I've had the government harassing me for 9.5 years, and you know, that's enough. You know, I'm not going to put up. See, here's the thing. Here's the risk I run. If I keep them in public school, CPS, DCBS, whatever you want to call them, is going to continuously go to my kids' school, yank them out of class. That's another F. They're going to keep getting Fs over and over and over again. There will be nothing I can do about it. Their grades are going to plummet, and then they're going to say, oh, look, Von Helm's kids are getting failing grades. Let's go out there and yank those kids away from him. Now, if you can't see that that's a setup, I don't know what to say to you, man, because it is a setup. It is a setup. They send CPS out there, to go out there and yank them out of that class. They get an F for the day. Then they yank them out again, another F and another F and another F. Then here about a week later, month later, year later, whatever. Then they come and they say, oh, look, Von Helden's kids are getting failing grades. He is not a good parent. We got to yank them kids away from him. And that's exactly what they would do. That's exactly what they would do. Well, you know what? I'm not going to give them I'm not going to give them the ability to do that. So, yeah, I'm taking them out of public school. because if their grades keep plummeting, that's exactly what they're going to say. They're going to say, I'm an unfit father. I'm not capable of raising my kids. And we got to get them kids away from that evil Von Helton guy, by God. And I'm not going to let them do it. I'm not going to let them do it. I asked CPS when they was out here. I said, you want me to leave Kentucky? Because I can do that. They never said a word. They never said one word to me. Because they know I'm telling the truth. They know I'm telling the truth. It's all a setup, man.
So, you know, I mean, heartfelt advice here, Vaughn. I would leave my kids in school. I would make sure they're well-groomed, well-dressed. You know what I mean?
But that's the thing, though. They'll never be well-groomed and well-dressed to suit them. Never. Like, when they come out to my house on Christmas Day and take my kids because my house is cluttered because there's Christmas wrapping everywhere, what does that tell you? That tells you they just want to aggravate and agitate. I've been told, I don't know if it's true, but I've been told that they get yelled at if they don't take your kids. If they go out on a report and they don't take your kids, they get yelled at. You got people out here. Listen, I used to lay carpet down here. All right. I know how these houses look inside. And they're horrible. They are horrible inside. I've laid carpet in them. I know. They're a hell of a lot worse looking than my trailer is. Is CPS going out there and taking those kids because of the horrible living conditions? Fuck no. You know why? Because they ain't got a bunch of assholes on the internet calling them every 5 minutes. Well, here's the thing. I had a very interesting conversation with a Kentucky congresswoman. All right. And we had a nice little chat about this whole thing. All right. And what led me to her was I saw an actual article online where 18 children had died in the state of Kentucky that year. Well, gee, Yvonne, why did they die? Oh, they died because CPS workers are short staffed in the state of Kentucky. And so when CPS was diverted that year to these calls, these nonsensical calls like what the trolls and haters have been doing, real children are being killed. Okay, so while CPS was talking to me Thanksgiving Eve, two children are dead. That's not an exaggeration. That's not me making assertions. They're literally, two children are literally dead. And like I said, me and a Kentucky congresswoman talked about this at length. A Kentucky congresswoman asked me, she said, Mr. Von Helton, I can't find none of my social workers. Where are they? I said, ma'am, I'm looking right at them. She said, you're what? I said, yes, my backyard is full of CPS workers. And she said, Mr. Von Helton, that will never happen again. And you know what? It didn't. So that tells me that they can do something about this if they wanted to. They could get these assholes off my back if they wanted to, but they don't want to. They don't want to. They could shut down these trolls tomorrow if they wanted to. They could find every one of these assholes and throw them in prison for filing a false claim to CPS. Which is a felony, by the way. They could have every one of these assholes arrested for committing a felony. Will they do it? No. Because it's a lot easier to come after me and harass the hell out of me than it is to track these guys down and put them behind bars where they belong. Now, I consider that a bit hypocritical, but, you know, that's just the way it is. So now the onus is on me to track down all these idiots and throw them behind bars so that they don't do this to somebody else's family. Because, see, my family is destroyed, and my whole rep is tarnished. Everything about everything. My kids are going to be the recipients of this after I'm gone. You think CPS is going to stop when these kids turn 18? No, it just begins. Because then, once I'm gone, they latch onto them, and they follow them around. And when they have kids, they go after their kids. It doesn't stop. And I have these idiots right here in this chat to thank for it. So I'm going to be suing these idiots after I get done with the local yokels here. They're going to get a lawsuit because it's a felony to file a false charge with CPS anyway. And I've got that much on them at least. But here's the problem. The problem is that nobody gives a rip. Nobody gives a rip. That Kentucky congresswoman was able to stop CPS from coming out to my house, all them workers. And now it's down to just two workers. You should have seen my backyard, Sister Sunshine. If I'd had a grill out there in the yard, it would have been a convention. I had about 20 or 30 CPS workers and at least 10 cops, all in my backyard. And for what? Oh, because some idiot on the internet thought he'd be cute. and say, yeah, man, Vaughn's trying to kill his kids. You got to get out there right away. They sent almost 100 people to my house because they thought my kids were being killed.
Well, just
has that person been prosecuted for a felony charge? No, because it's easier to harass me than it is to track these people down and throw them behind bars where they belong.
Well,
and now I'm carrying this for the rest of my life. My kids will be carrying it for the rest of their lives. And when they have children, those children will be followed around by CPS too, because of a bunch of assholes on the internet.
I tell you what, Vaughn, if you had your time back again, would you not have gone on the internet?
What's that?
If you could turn back time, you had the choice, would you not have bothered to go on the internet?
Yeah, well, that's the thing. That's the thing about this whole mess.
Because I know I wouldn't have done.
Yeah, well, see, the thing of it is, though, I wouldn't have found my ex-wife. We wouldn't have had 5 wonderful years. We had 5 wonderful years before the trolls intervened. We had 5 wonderful years. Can you imagine a marriage where you never argue with your spouse? Can you imagine a marriage where you finish each other's sentences and where every day is like Camelot?
You are labeling me as racist, sir, and I'm not racist. Telling somebody to grow the fuck up doesn't matter what color the goddamn skin is. But when I'm on the street, and I see,
Vaughn, you made it obvious you were talking about black people.
Fucking white.
Black people have a lot of growing up.
Making jokes about it. I think I ought to speak out. I think I ought to not be silenced. And when I see that shit going on with my own goddamn eyes, and then nobody wants to talk about it, nobody wants to say it on it, because
you need
to fucking black,
then
that pisses me off. That's called counter racism or opposite racism, and it's just as fucking wrong as regular racism.
You need
in my
to
humble
calm
opinion.
Down, dude.
And I'm tired of seeing white folks getting talked to like dogs, which I've seen it happen with my own eyes, and it happens in Cincinnati, Ohio. They fucking run the streets like goddamn wild dogs, running with this fucking gangbanger shit and this fucking other bullshit. And nobody wants to say jack squat, sitting there using their own fucking nigger word. And but if a white person or an Indian like myself or somebody else says it, oh, it's the worst thing in the world. Well, fuck
you.
When the nigger stops using the N-word, I'll stop using it, goddammit. And that doesn't make me racist. So fuck y'all.
Well, folks, I think let's end on a high note. There was some classic Von Helton. If you're new to the situation, folks, I appreciate each and every one of you for coming out and watching this evening. On your way out, please remember, hit the X on the chat if you're on a phone. Hit the thumbs up. I would really appreciate that. Like I said, right now we are in a lulz lull. We have been spoiled. Oh, we have been spoiled. But I think this is the calm before the storm. We got to start seriously thinking, folks, about the golden lulz cow. Who are we going to position into the top three? I just, you know, we can talk about that more in depth as June approaches, but that's a halfway mark. We got to start really thinking ahead. We got to start thinking about this. Folks, it's a serious matter. Let me take the last little swiggy swig. Good to the last drop. And with that, I think I will bid you adieu. Thank you for joining, and keep your eyes open. As soon as